Sports Ohio, the heart of a fan.
Tonight, Ohtani and Trout and the Angels come to town to open up a three-game set against the Cleveland Guardians. A lefty is on the hill. Stephen Kwan is the best hitter against lefties for the Cleveland Guardians. He'll be leading off tonight as Cleveland tries and takes game one against Los Angeles. Guardians Live coming up right now. Welcome in to Guardians Live, presented by your Northern Ohio GMC dealers. Well, tonight here in downtown Cleveland, it is cloudy, but relatively warm compared to where we've been. Right now, temperature sitting at 73 degrees. Fans are actually in baseball gear and getting ready for tonight's showdown between the Angels and the Guardians. Game one in this three-game weekend set here at Progressive Field. Hi again, everybody. Great to have you along here in right center field, along with Chris Jimenez, Al Pawlowski. And Chris, here we go tonight. Welcome back, and you get the Angels.
I know. I see some shorts out here. That's a great sign. We get the Angels, Ohtani, Trout. What's not to like about the weather right now? This is going to be a good weekend, I have a feeling.
I think it's going to be a lot of fun. So let's get going. Top of the order, some things to keep in mind for tonight's game between the Guardians and the Angels. And first up, it's Logan Allen. He'll be making the start tonight for Cleveland. This will be his fourth major league start. He's allowed two earned runs or fewer in each of his first three.
You're right. And I think consistency is going to be the key again tonight. You know, if he can continue to keep the ball down in the zone like we're seeing here, I think he's going to be in a good spot. This is a tough lineup. Listen, any lineup that has Ohtani and Trout, arguably the two best players in our game right now, if he can keep the ball down there, there's not much bad that's going to happen to you.
You'll let me right into number two, and that's the Angels have been flying high. 51 home runs this season. It's tied for second in the American League. So defensively, they're not good. Offensively, they're very good.
Yeah, usually if you're not good off or defensively, you better darn sure be good offensively. Thankfully for them, they are. They're number eight in all of baseball this year in offense. Number nine versus left-handed pitchers is what we're throwing out there tonight. So, again, consistency for Logan Allen, keeping that ball down in the zone, we're going to be better off.
All right, and finally, something's not right, Chris, as in the pitcher throwing tonight for the Angels. Back tomorrow and Sunday, they're throwing three lefties against us, and lefties haven't been great for Cleveland hitters.
I'm wondering if I could possibly come out of retirement for this. That's the only pitcher that I faced. So these three guys throw with the right hand, which is the left hand.
I get you. The correct hand versus the left.
There you go.
Very well played. Yeah, and Cleveland is just 4-11 against left-handed starters this year, so something's got to change.
Yes. I mean, listen, I think ultimately it's looking for where you're going to get a pitch, right? Not expanding the strike zone as much as they have been lately. Looking for the ball up in the zone, I think that's huge going forward. For the next 3 days in particular, listen, this is three very considerably close pitchers in what we're talking about. The fastball location, the soft changeups, the little breaking ball that they throw, where they like to throw it. Pushing these guys up in the zone, out over the plate, is going to be huge for this team going forward.
Certainly will. And Chris Villeca, the hitting coach for the Guardians, talked about the team's recent struggles. Here's what he had to say.
The other team gets paid too. So, you know, we've run into some good arms. You know, we're going to keep grinding away, competing with these guys. You know, it hasn't been good. You know, we can't keep making excuses, like had the same record last year and things like that. I think there's different expectations, not just internally, but externally, that, you know, we have to live up to. And, you know, we're going to keep competing. It's a long season and, you know, weather the storm right now. It is what it is. You know, we're not going to dig our head in the sand with those things. You know, I think internally, you know, we're going to keep going about our business the same way and, you know, stay consistent with our messaging. Nothing's changed from last year to this year, you know, other than some early on results. So, you know, we're going to keep competing. And, you know, I know the results haven't necessarily been here, but, you know, if we stay positive with these guys, stay consistent with that, you know, I believe in them and we're going to come out the other end. I think, you know, we heard that same narrative last year. You know, I think we have a lefty heavy lineup. So, you know, I think teams know that, you know, if teams are coming at us with lefties, we see that. We see different bullpens with lefties. So it's something we're going to have to make an adjustment to. But, you know, keep competing. It's still early.
All right, Chris. That Chris talked a lot about hitting left-handers,
right.
But he also talked about expectations. I thought that was the key, internally and externally. Last year, not high expectations for the Guardians. This year, yeah, a lot of people thought they should be on top in the Central.
And I still think ultimately it's going to get there, right? I mean, overall, the season is still really young. I mean, we're talking about May 12th here. We're a quarter of the way through the season, if that. I think what he said that really struck me was consistent messaging, to be completely honest with you. It's the same, essentially, group of guys, right? And it's just now we're getting out of the colder weather into a little bit nicer weather, which, again, you know, I see some shorts around here. That's a good thing. Balls have a tendency to fly a little bit further. It's tough, honestly, mentally, when you're out there and you barrel up a ball to right center and it doesn't go anywhere, you know, that plays tricks on you as a hitter at times. And I think we're starting to see the end of that now. That consistent messaging we will start to see come through at some point here.
All right, so then the lefties. That's the other part of this equation. And Cleveland's just 4-11 against lefties. Here's the three starters we'll see in this weekend series. Tonight, Tyler Anderson. Tomorrow, Reed Detmers. Sunday, Patrick Sandoval.
Right, and I think if you look at Tyler Anderson tonight in particular, you know, opposing teams are hitting 283 with an 878 OPS against him. Now, the reason I bring those up, that was one thing that I love to look for. Yeah. I, if a guy was throwing, if his batting average against was higher than mine, I felt like I had a pretty good chance that day.
Well, here's a look at the pitching arsenal for Tyler Anderson. We're going to see the fastball most of the time. Right. He's a fastball changeup guy, and we'll also see that cutter mixed in.
Yeah, from occasion. You know, I think ultimately, again, you look at, you can see the play sense here. It's getting the ball up and out over the strike zone. Not expanding our strike zones as hitters is a huge part of this. Getting him early in the count, up in the zone, taking advantage of those pitches. Yep. You know, that's going to be key tonight. Staying up the middle of the field, taking advantage of those pitches up in the zone, and not trying to do too much.
Here's a look at the lineup for the Guardians. It's brought to you by your Northern Ohio GMC dealers. So there's some righties here, but there's some lefties too. Kwan, Naylor, and Jimenez. Kwan, the best left on left for Cleveland. Right. But Ahmed Rosario, career numbers against the Angels, Chris, 340, couple of home runs in 13 games. You've got a lefty on the hill. You need Ahmed tonight.
Yes, you definitely do. Again, like I said, just getting that ball up in the strike zone. This is the ball what he loves to handle. He doesn't try to do too much, which is why I like him so much, especially tonight. Funny stat for you, he's 61st in baseball out of all qualified hitters at hard hit percentage. I think that's going to come into play tonight.
All right, let's see if he does it tonight. Maybe going deep for Cleveland. It would be nice to see, for sure. All right, let's take a look now at making every moment more. It's brought to you by FanDuel, where we give you a three-legged parlay and some things that we think if you play together, it just might be a winner. So first up, we're going to go with Logan Allen to go over 4.5 on strikeouts.
I like
his history.
Yeah, this was my pick right here. I really like this tonight. Again, a young man who can command the strike zone. There is some swing and miss in this lineup. I think this is a good combination.
All right, what about Ahmed to get a base hit to? That's minus 350, so, you know, people beat that.
We just talked about him, you know, getting that ball up in the zone. He's a little bit of a free swinger. Again, I feel pretty good about it.
And Jose and RBI, he gets a lot of them for Cleveland.
He definitely does. Arguably the best hitter on this team. Coming up in huge clutch situations, just knows how to slow the game down.
Well, right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets guaranteed when you place your first $5 bet. Download the FanDuel app now and start making every moment more. Well, when we come back here on Guardians Live, there are superstars in Cleveland. Trout, Ohtani. Two of the best baseball players in the entire world are here tonight, tomorrow, and Sunday. Talk more about these two and what they bring to the table next.
There's something that's been missing in the debate.
Think analysis.
Now he goes into his contract year. What do you do with this guy?
Think advanced metrics.
The new rules are having an impact, and I'll bottom line it.
Think MLB Now, the show for the thinking fan. Only on MLB Network. The next generation of baseball has arrived.
And I am here for it.
Keep an eye on the new faces of baseball. On Off Base, the modern baseball show for the modern baseball fan.
It's all about things you haven't seen before.
Only on MLB Network. When it's about to go down,
this is the story of the night.
MLB Tonight takes you there.
We will watch it all together live.
He's done it, 62. How about that?
Big moments.
Oh, baby. 3,000 hits.
Big reactions.
Bobby Witt Jr.'s first big league knock.
And big interviews.
What was the first thing going through your mind?
Join TV's best baseball analysts for a big night of baseball. Every night, only on MLB Network's MLB Tonight.
These new bases are wider than the old ones.
Is he focused on the size of the new bases?
Now it will be easier to steal second base.
Is he thinking about stealing second base?
7 years in the league.
And he's never stolen a single base. Don't steal second base.
The pitcher's not looking.
I am not looking.
This is Chris Bryant. This is Christopher Russo. And this is the High Heat Hot Seat. Chris Bryant plays hard so he doesn't end up here. High Heat with Christopher Russo.
Help GMC. Visit your Northern Ohio GMC dealer for a test drive today. And by Menards. Save big money at Menards on all your home improvement needs. Guardians and Angels tonight here in downtown Cleveland. First of a three-step between these two clubs. First pitch coming up in less than 29 minutes right here on Bally Sports Great Lakes. Logan Allen will take on Tyler Anderson. A couple of left-handers tonight for both Cleveland and the Angels. Well, what about a couple of months ago? The championship of the World Baseball Classic, Ohtani versus Trout, teammates, of course, with the Angels, but not teammates here. What a moment.
No, my goodness. This was a moment that most of us, I know I was watching it, I was fired up for this. Ultimately, did not go Team USA's way, but this is exactly what you want if you're Major League Baseball. It's two best players in the biggest moment.
Well, Shohei Ohtani can do it all. He can hit, he can pitch. Here's Terry Francona with more on Ohtani.
You know, when he's in the batter's box, it doesn't make you feel good when you're in our uniform. For the game of baseball, it's great. And from everything I've heard from talking to Nev, you know, he's just a big kid that loves playing baseball, which I love hearing. I think that bodes well for our game. It's, you know, I think when you use the word generational, I don't think that's a too big of an adjective. You know, that's kind of what he is. I mean, I was looking at his pitching numbers. They're stupid. You know, and he's hitting and running, and there's nothing he can't do. It's impressive. It's beyond impressive.
You know, it's crazy to think there is somebody like an Ohtani in today's
yes.
game who can be a true ace on the hill and strike everybody out, it seems, but then also at the plate be one of the game's most feared hitters.
You know, I truly believe we will never see a player like this again, to be completely honest with you. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to look at a guy that is not only a true ace on the mound with ace-caliber stuff, but, oh, yeah, by the way, he's also, like, the top five greatest hitters we've seen this, you know, since he became a major leaguer. So if you get an opportunity to really get a chance to watch him, you heard what Tito said. He's just a big kid playing baseball.
Yeah.
And I know Tito really well. He's also a big kid managing baseball players.
Right.
So I think it's a good combo for the game all around.
Certainly is. There's another guy named Trout who's not too bad either.
Right.
Probably the best hitter in the game as we take a look at the Angels lineup brought to you by your Northern Ohio GMC dealers. When he's right, that is Mike Trout. And well, he's been fairly right so far this
right.
year.
Yeah, I think all he has to do is be healthy to be right, because he is arguably the best player in our game. I mean, when you have these two guys together on a team, it not only does it lengthen up this lineup,
yeah.
but it gives all these other guys opportunities, because nobody wants to pitch to those two guys.
Well, and a lot of times they're back-to-back in the order,
exactly.
too. So you've got Ohtani. Do you want to deal with him? No, you want to deal with Trout? I mean, the answer is no to either one. And then when Anthony Rendon is feeling pretty good, he's
sure.
not a bad hitter either.
Right. You know, that's a good thing to have if you're the Anaheim Angels, or excuse me, the Los Angeles Angels. You know, again, look at this swing right there. The ball down in the zone. You can't pitch Mike Trout anywhere, seemingly. So that's what makes it so tough to pitch to these guys. And trying to figure out who you want to pick on. Trying to navigate a lineup. If you're Cam Gallagher tonight, it's going to be a very difficult thing.
Yeah, it certainly is. And if you're catching it, what do you tell Logan Allen, who's going tonight, Chris? How are you trying to work these guys?
Yeah, I think key to Logan Allen's night tonight is make these guys aware up. Up in the zone. Ohtani struggles against left-handed pitching up in the zone, and by struggles I mean like 240, so that's considerably better than most of us can do. But if you can make him aware of up and in the zone, Mike Trout, that's also a good spot for him, up and away to, again, you're gonna have to get these guys out in at some point.
Yep.
But making them aware of up to go out to your breaking stuff, I think, is going to be a huge key for them tonight.
All right, let's talk a little bit more about Logan Allen making his fourth major league start tonight. The first three have been fairly impressive, allowing two runs or less. Here's a left-hander that Cleveland, they've been looking for a left-handed starter for years, Chris. Maybe this is the guy that sticks and becomes that dominating lefty they've been looking for.
I think he could be. If you look at him, he has that bulldog-type mentality. Not afraid to challenge people in the strike zone. Doesn't matter if it's Trout, Ohtani, which will obviously be his biggest test in his young career so far, but I look for him to challenge these guys in the strike zone, especially up tonight.
What do you like about his arsenal?
I love the fact that he's a three-pitch mix, essentially, right? Fastball, changeup with the sweeper. That's a new word going around, the sweeper.
Isn't it just a slider?
In my mind, yes. But what do I know? I'm not a pitcher.
Right on. Well, there's a look at what we'll see tonight from Logan Allen. So fastball majority of the time.
Right.
But, you know, the other half of the time, he'll mix it between the change, the sweeper, and then he's got that cutter, too. He has multiple pitches.
He
also has pretty good command for a young kid.
He really does. And I think key tonight for him as well, not getting so one-pitch centric, right? Not getting too fastball heavy. As you can see there, he was 50% fastballs in his young start to his career here. I think getting and mixing pitches, mixing zones, making guys aware of up, but mixing in his three other pitches is going to be huge.
You surprised a guy like this who had success in the minors, comes up here and is having really that same sort of success?
Not at all. Honestly, it's a mentality thing. If you sit there and you command the strike zone and you challenge the strike zone, have that bulldog type mentality, this is what you're going to get.
Like you had in that batter's box with the Rangers.
That's right.
There you go.
That's
when
exactly
we come back, we'll hear more from the Bulldog. And Stephen Kwan, a special moment last year for him in Seattle. I think you know who his biggest influence just might be. If not, we'll shed some light on it. Plus more on Kwan and why he's so good. Stay here.
Imagine an entire channel dedicated to taking you to the most exciting moments in baseball as they happen.
It's gone!
With live look-ins to clutch at bats.
A walk-off flare!
And players on the edge of making history.
This could be it! 62!
It's the best seat in the house at every ballpark. All commercial free.
Can you believe it?
MLB Network Strike Zone. Wednesdays and Fridays, all season long. The next generation of baseball has arrived.
And I am here for it.
Keep an eye on the new faces of baseball on Off Base, the modern baseball show for the modern baseball fan.
It's all about things you haven't seen before.
Only on MLB Network.
Chisholm looking up. Goodbye. Make him mad, and he does that. Third home run of the season for Jose Ramirez. And he clobbers one. Deep left. Go to the bleachers, baby. Home run number two on the year for Josh Bell. Back-to-back home runs for the Guardians.
Guardians Live is brought to you by Akron Children's Hospital. Quick Care Online connects you with primary care for kids' minor illnesses from wherever you are. By the Ohio Department of Public Safety. Hey, Ohio, phones down while you're driving. It's now the law. And by Labatt Blue, reminding you to share a good-natured Canadian Pilsner. Guardians and then Angels, what's going on out there? Stephen Kwan.
It's a nice stretch.
Getting some
session.
Assistance from Slider. I don't know if he wants that assistance. There, Slider got away from him. Guess he'll be okay. That's good to see. Well, tonight, here at the ballpark, it's Asian American Pacific Islanders celebration night tonight. Stephen Kwan had a big influence on his career. Here he is with more.
Oh, my gosh. It was an honor. I got a jersey signed from him and everything. I had to. I haven't met him yet. I didn't want to disturb him on his weekend, but... No, it was big. It almost kind of felt storybook because my parents were there as well. My mom was there. I got into Ichiro because my grandma had the Japanese news network every day. And no matter what Ichiro did, if he went 0 for 5 or 5 for 5, they got highlights of him. So having my mom there and kind of seeing the highlights of him coming up, that was really special.
Welcome back, Chris Jimenez, Al Pulaski. So Stephen Kwan last year in Seattle when they put Ichiro in Seattle's Hall of Fame, as he said, quite a moment for him. Sure. That's the guy that he has modeled a lot of his game after. And if you watch him at the plate, you can definitely see the influence.
You absolutely can see the influence of Ichiro and Stephen Kwan's swing, his defensive prowess out there, the way he runs the bases. I mean, he's pretty much modeled his entire career so far to this point off of Ichiro. It's pretty impressive.
Not a bad guy to model your career
after. No, not at all.
Either. So let's go play sense on Stephen Kwan. At the plate, Chris, he hits better against lefties than righties, but really he's equal.
He's pretty good all the way around. Let's be honest.
Why is he so strong against either arm? It doesn't matter.
You know what? I think his ability to stay balanced through his swing. I mean, you saw right there his getting his foot down, his front foot down early, staying balanced through the strikes on this. You can see right here, here's a breaking ball right in the heart of the plate. Not trying to do too much. Letting the ball get deep on him, coming back. Same thing right here. This was for a big homer this past week. You know, I think it even surprised him. It definitely surprised Alcala because he pointed up, thought it was a pop-up, and the ball ended up 30 feet over the fence.
It certainly did. I think the pitcher was hoping that it was a pop-up.
I think he was, yes.
And then defensively, too. I mean, here he is playing the Green Monster.
Yes.
And he makes a perfect throw to set.
And trust me, this is a very, very difficult play right here. Learning how to play that monster is tough, especially from a visiting team standpoint, where there's a lot of different angles and notches that the ball can hit out there. And bounce the way he did, he was able to keep his momentum going. Perfect, grab the ball, make a great throw, strong throw to second base.
Once he sees the top of the order position in the lineup last year, he's pretty much stayed there, 184 career games. Yeah, some pretty impressive numbers for the leadoff man.
Yeah, again, a guy who does not strike out a ton, makes a ton of contact. His ability to stay in the middle part of the zone, not try to do too much. He is the premier leadoff hitter in baseball. That's exactly what you want that guy to do up there.
Probably the most surprising thing to me, and perhaps to you, or, you know, we've seen him in the minors. He also had a good eye, but, you know, his play discipline, his understanding of the strike zone, so rarely you see a rookie come up with this sort of understanding. Heck, there's some veterans that don't have this understanding of the strike zone.
You're absolutely right. I was one of them. Trust me. You know, again, having the ability to control a strike zone for a young player is huge, right? I mean, that gets your career off to a great start, but it also allows you to get better pitches to hit overall. You know, if you're not chasing balls outside of the zone, me as a catcher, I know I can't go out there, so I have to come within the strike zone to get you out. That's where he can barrel up baseballs, use the big part of the field, the entire field, and look what we've seen.
Yeah.
292 average is pretty darn good to start your career.
He sees a lot of pitches, and he almost always puts a good swing on the ball, even if it's an out.
Balance.
Yeah. Balance is key. When we come back here on Guardians Live, still more before first pitch. Talk a little bit about four runners. That's our tease for you. Four runners.
This is a good tease.
You like it?
I like that.
It's Logan Allen versus Mike Trout and Shohei Ohtani tonight here in Cleveland.
This is Mookie Betts. This is Christopher Russo. And this is the High Heat Hot Seat. Mookie Betts plays hard so he doesn't end up here. High Heat with Christopher Russo, helping players play harder on MLB Network.
The hot dog of the game beat roast beef at the Ritz.
I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'ma do what? That's on me. Me and boy, but I keep it OG. No, you can't shine if you stay low key. That's on me, on me, on me. I'ma do what? That's on me. Me and boy, but I keep it OG. No, you can't shine if you stay low key. That's on me, on me, on me. Don't want that shit, but that's on me. Build that house, I got the keys. They say you can't shine if you stay low key. That's on me, on me.
Watch games and coverage all day, every day, your way on MLB Network.
GMC dealer for a test drive today. By the Calvetta Brothers Floor Show, it's time to fall in love again with your home. And by Union Home Mortgage, promises kept. Josh Naylor has continued with his Cooking with Naylor program earlier today, where Josh and his mom Janice cook for the Ronald McDonald House and members mom Megan and son Major. And they had such a great time. They played a little basketball earlier today on the field here. They played some catch. Pretty good pitch by Major.
Not
they
bad.
Catch, but maybe Bo gave Josh some tips on catching.
See, here's the thing, though. You mess around like that, and the wrong people see it, the next thing you know, position change.
Exactly. He'll be a left-handed catcher. And the score squares won the cooking contest today.
I like that.
The score squares. Hey. Time for the Calvetta Brothers Floor Show. It's time to fall in love again. How about Josh Naylor in Boston?
Yeah, you got to love that. I mean, this was a big knock for him right here. Hopefully, this is something that can continue to keep him going in the right direction. You know what? Sometimes taking your mind off of baseball for a few minutes is a great thing. Yeah. Getting a chance to go out in the community, do some stuff with the community, just get back to being you as a person. Let all the worries and everything that comes along with baseball and the struggles that you may have leave your side for a minute. Allows you to kind of free yourself up and get yourself going again.
A lot of times, Chris, too, obviously Jose Ramirez important, Stephen Kwan having a good year, but when this team's going well offensively, Josh Naylor's also going well offensively.
He is one of the keys that makes this offense go around. Listen, he's a fire starter. He's a spark plug in this offense. We've seen how excitable and ecstatic he can be at times on the field, and the guys love him in the clubhouse. He needs to get himself going, but again, it's just slowing himself down, getting the good pitches to hit, and the next thing you know, the rest of it takes care of itself.
Sure. Now, remember I said four-runner?
Yes.
Remember that, Chris? You couldn't wait for it. Here it is. It's our walk-off stat. Four or more, the Guardians 11-2. When they score four or more, guess what? They're only 6-18 when they do not. So score four tonight for Logan Allen.
Sounds like a simple plan to me. Score four and look no more, because that's a W.
I like it. You kind of made a little rhyme.
You see what
there,
I did
too.
There?
I did.
See what I did.
I did. I mean, you're a poet and you don't know it.
Hey. To you and I together, I'm not going to lie. That's pretty impressive.
All right. Yeah, I don't know if we'll have any of our poems published, but give it a shot. Coming up next, Matt Underwood, Rick Manning, Andre Knott, Chris Jimenez, and I'll be back with you here very soon to talk a little Ohtani and Trout. Stay tuned.
An 04 champ.
Well, hello.
A 2013 champ.
This is going to be fun. Let's get it on.
And a host who keeps them both in check.
Players know who you guys are, right?
Intentional Talk on MLB Network.
Hey fans, I'm breaking down MLB Play. I think they're the best MLB games. Now my personal favorite, Beat the Streak. Pick who you'll think will get a hit building your own streak. It's all on you, baby. You can win 5.6 million bucks. The streak's alive! Next up, Pickle. Guess the player in the fewest number of tries. Got him! And there's other games like Bingo, a race to be first. Bingo! MLB Play. Great games, great prizes, and it's all free. No purchase necessary. Restrictions apply. See official rules and enter at MLB.com/play. Oh yeah! I'ma do work, that's on me.
Watch games and coverage all day, every day, your way on MLB Network. Valley Sports Great Lakes and Valley Sports Ohio, the heart of the fan.
Yeah.
temperature has finally delivered some warm weather to the North Coast. And on those warm breezes come the Los Angeles Angels. It's a three-game series beginning tonight as the Guardians continue their longest homestand of the season. Hi again, everyone. Matt Underwood alongside Rick Manning. We'll check in with Andre Knott here shortly. The Angels arrive in town. Okay, they call themselves the Los Angeles Angels. They're not necessarily Hollywood, Rick, but they have two of the biggest stars in the game.
I'm going to tell you, if you're a pitcher at home, do not watch these two swing the bats because it's not good for you. These two guys, that may be two of the best players in all of baseball when you think about it. They've been together on that team for a few years, and they can mash. They can score. And I'll tell you what, they are a team that is scary only because you've got these two guys. Shohei Ohtani, he can not only hit home runs, you can see third most in MLB, 88 since 21, but he can pitch, and it's amazing. He's one of the better pitchers in the game, 28-12 with a 271. And then Mike Trout, 300 career hitter. He's been in there now for starting his second decade. You know, and so many home runs. Those two guys are something special to watch. It's a treat.
All right, it'll be up to Logan Allen to deal with them tonight. Let's check out our Kia player profile. And, Rick, Allen's making his fourth start, and in his first three outings, he has not allowed more than two runs.
No, he's aggressive, and he's got three good pitches. He's got a good changeup, a good slider, and he locates his fastball. He uses both sides of the plate. He's got a 270 ERA. He walked five, struck out 19. He's just learning, and he's getting better every time he toes the rubber.
The Guardians will see three left-handed starters coming at him from the Angels pitching staff this weekend during the series. We'll be back with tonight's first pitch. We'll check in with Al Pawlowski and Chris Jimenez, and we'll hear from Andre Knott straight ahead. Cleveland Guardians baseball is brought to you by your Northern Ohio Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. Destination Cleveland. Watch at thisiscleveland.com. By DHL Supply Chain, now hiring for a wide range of salaried managerial and operational roles. Apply today at joindhl.com. And by Shealy's, the best things in life happen at home.
An 04 champ.
Well, hello.
A 2013 champ.
This is going to be fun. Let's get it on.
And a host who keeps them both in check.
Players know who you guys are, right?
Intentional Talk on MLB Network.
Imagine an entire channel dedicated to taking you to the most exciting moments in baseball as they happen.
It's gone!
With live look-ins to clutch at bats.
A walk-off flare!
And players on the edge of making history.
This could be it! 62!
It's the best seat in the house at every ballpark. All commercial free.
Can you believe it?
MLB Network Strike Zone. Wednesdays and Fridays, all season long. Think baseball.
There's something that's been missing in the debate.
Think analysis.
Now he goes into his contract year. What do you do with this guy?
Think advanced metrics.
The new rules are having an impact, and I'll bottom line it.
Think MLB Now, the show for the thinking fan. Only on MLB Network.
Here tonight, there's Josh Bell. He'll be hitting cleanup for the Guards as they try to win this first game. the three-game set against the Los Angeles Angels. Welcome back to Right Center. Alongside Chris Gimenez, Al Pulowski. So whenever you talk Angels, of course, Trout and Ohtani come to mind immediately. And this past winter, just a couple of months ago, they staged a moment in the World Baseball Classic that I think everybody that's a baseball fan loved. Even though we wanted Trout to come out on top for our country, but Shohei Ohtani versus Trout, this was special.
This was the matchup of a lifetime right here. You know, Rob Manfred has to be ecstatic that this is how this ended up playing out. The two best players in our game today fighting head-to-head. Ohtani ended up going ahead in that one. Let's hope we get another chance to even the score in 4 years.
It was certainly a special moment in the World Baseball Classic, and Ohtani got his teammate Mike Trout. Today they're in the same lineup together. Andre now joins us. And Andre, whenever the Angels come to town, those two guys, Trout and Ohtani, they're pretty special.
Absolutely. Chris, you're right. Manfred got something right for once. I mean, let's move on to today. You talk about with the Guardians and where their offense is right now, and you guys mentioned it in the open, Matt and Rick. There's another lefty on the mound tonight. They're going to do another one tomorrow as well as Sunday. Three lefties tonight is what they're going to go against in this trip. And you look at what they are. They're 4-11 against them. So I asked Chris Villeca, what is the difference than what they have to do against lefties?
You know, we heard that same narrative last year. You know, I think we have a lefty-heavy lineup. So, you know, I think teams know that. You know, if teams are coming at us with lefties, we see that. We see different bullpens with lefties. So it's something we're going to have to make an adjustment to. But, you know, keep competing. It's still early. As youthful as we were last year, you know, having 500, 600 at-bats in the big leagues doesn't make you a veteran right away. So I think, you know, we're taking some of those lumps and, you know, having to make adjustments on the fly. You know, I think this is, in the long run, going to be, you know, a good thing for us. And, you know, we're going to learn for it and from it and, you know, be able to come out the other side.
The question is, Arch, how long do they have? We've talked about it ad nauseum at this point in time, the issues they've had. I know the number that we'll get into later on tonight is what they've done with runners in scoring position. They got to get guys on and get guys first and third and get more than one or two runs in those situations. Otherwise, they're going to stay in the same issues and problems they've had all season.
Well, yeah, and one thing when they're facing all the left-handers, it neutralizes this lineup. When Ramirez is hitting, yes, the 156 against lefties, Naylor is not doing anything. I don't even know if he has an RBI against lefties. And Jimenez, those are the guys that it's really hurt. So they've got to get everybody going. It doesn't matter lefties or righties. They haven't been doing a job. But we'll talk about the runners in scoring position later, especially when they're not hitting home runs. But right now, it'll be Logan Allen who's going to get the start. He will be our Chevrolet starting pitcher for today's game. And Logan Allen will be making his fourth start of his career. The 24-year-older, this will be his third start right here in this ballpark. So he's been very good. He's gone out every outing. He's gone six innings in his first start, five in his second, five and two-thirds in his third. He's moved the ball around. I like the way he attacks the strike zone. He's going to see a different lineup every time he goes out there now because he's just, you know, four games into his career. So let's see what he's got for the Angels tonight.
Let's take a look at Phil Nevin's starting lineup for the Angels tonight. Mike Trout, the man in your picture, will follow Taylor Ward, the leadoff hitter, then Shohei Ohtani, the DH. Anthony Rendon in the cleanup spot, followed by Hunter Renfroe. Brandon Drury will bat sixth. Gio Urshela in the seventh hole. Matt Theis, the catcher, hitting eighth. And Zach Neto, the shortstop, will bat ninth.
Defensively for the Guardians, looks like this. Brought to you by Rally House. Kwan is in left, Straw is in center. Arias gets another start in right field. On the infield, Ramirez, Rosario, Jimenez, and Naylor, third to first. And Gallagher will be doing the catching. It was a late scratch. Zunino came out, had some neck tightness, so Cam Gallagher will be doing the catching tonight.
Manny Gonzalez will call the balls and strikes tonight. Junior Valentine is your first base umpire. Adrian Johnson, the crew chief, is down at second, and Quinn Walcott is your third base umpire this evening. Last year, the Angels won the season series against Cleveland, winning 4 out of 7. And that was a change in direction because the Guardians have really dominated the Angels for several years. Over the last 3 years that they have played head-to-head, Cleveland's record, including last year, is 14-5 against the Angels. Here we go. Logan Allen winds it up, and tonight's first pitch is a fastball strike. Game time temperature, 70 degrees, overcast skies, no breeze at the moment. So Swung on and missed.
Change up. I like that fastball change up. And you can see he had him out front already on the second pitch of the game. He was looking dead red.
And the 0-2 up high. Taylor Ward began the month of May on a tear. He had 11 hits in his first six games of the month. But since then, 0 for his last 9. Make it 0 for his last 10 as Logan Allen strikes him out. Storylines tonight are brought to you by Wayside Furniture. It's a buzzsaw at the top of that Halos lineup with Mike Trout, Shohei Ohtani, and Anthony Rendon. You got to get at least 4. I mean, against the Angels, you better score at least 4 runs. This is not an easy lineup to contain. They average 5 runs per game. Actually, a little more than 5 runs a game. That's 5th best in the American League. Rick, in their 18 losses, they're averaging over 4 runs a game.
Yeah, they can score, and that's why they'll beat a lot of teams. Second in the league in home run, they've hit 51 as a team.
1-1.
But they don't run much. And they've given up the most unearned runs defensively. They're the worst team.
Tried to hold up, but he went around. And it's 1-2. Phil Nevin, Angels manager. Angels come in 20-18. 3.5 games back of Texas in the AL West. Andres Jimenez takes care of that. 2-0. Angels are very consistent home and road. They're 10-9 at home and 10-9 away from Southern California.
Yeah, they're starting this. What is it? 6-game road trip here. They're coming to Cleveland and then heading to Baltimore from here.
First pitch breaking ball in there for a strike to Shohei Ohtani. He's only hit 359 in his last 13 games. Just dipped low with a fastball. In those 13 games, 8 extra base hits and 11 runs batted in. Two balls and a strike. Ohtani has only been intentionally walked once this year, but he's now drawn 16 walks on the season. So some of those may not register as intentional, but they may be the old unintentional.
Oh, yeah, but then when you're hitting behind a guy like that, like Rendon is, and, you know, that's when he's got to get rolling. And Rendon in the last 2 weeks has been doing very well.
Batting 407 in the month of May.
He's hit safely in 13 of the 14 games.
In the air, center field. Miles Straw drifting back onto the track, pulls it down to retire the side. The Guardians are coming to bat.
If sports fans built a streaming service.
What's going on?
I think we found a way to stop fans from destroying their TVs when their teams lose.
How's it work?
Hey, Charlie, Philly lost.
I'm sorry, I'm going to have to put you on hold for just 1 second. Okay.
No!
Yeah, we need a little bit of water splashing around this one.
Bob Ross Channel. It's freaking genius.
It's even a little over here.
Live TV and sports and more, but mostly sports. That's Fubo!
To get your best night's sleep, you need to sleep in something extraordinary. Woven with a silky softness unlike any other. From organic threads that are slow spun and finished in flame. Made from an ingredient so rare, less than 1% of the world's cotton meets our quality. It's the most extraordinary fabric ever made. Only from Boll & Branch.
be making the start, brought to you by Chevrolet. And now this is the very first start against the Guardians. He's been at baseball since 2016. So this is never pitched in this ballpark or against this lineup, but the lefty went 15-5 last year with the Dodgers.
The lineup he will face for Terry Francona's Cleveland Guardians, brought to you by Progressive. It's Stephen Kwan, Ahmed Rosario, and Jose Ramirez at the top. Josh Bell will DH. Josh Naylor hitting fifth. Gabriel Arias in the sixth hole. Then Andres Jimenez, Miles Straw, and Cam Gallagher catching tonight. That's ninth. Anderson is a crafty left-hander. Is no way to describe him. You watch the delivery. He's got the leg pump. Tries to get the hitter to fall for some deception.
Yeah, and you know what? His fastball is getting knocked around the ballpark. So you may, he's going to have to be perfect with it or miss, and then his secondary stuff is going to have to be around the plate or in the zone.
Popped up foul out of play. Rick, it's interesting. When you look at Anderson, he's made six starts. Three of those starts came against Toronto, Boston, and Kansas City consecutively. And he gave up 16 earned runs in 14 innings. In his other three starts, he's given up just three runs in 17 and two-thirds innings of work. So which Tyler Anderson are you going to get tonight? There's a bullet to first. Nice play by Giovanni Urshela, who takes it to the bag for out number one. Statcast 3D, powered by Google Cloud. Take a look at the pitches that Tyler Anderson features, and then you'll get a look at what hitters have batted against those pitches.
Yeah, watch the fastball. They do a number of job. 357 in against the fastball, and then his other off-speed pitches down a little bit, but you better hit his fastball when he gives it, and he's going to try and paint it every time he throws it.
Generous call there for Anderson as he gets ahead of Ahmed Rosario.
Matt, you know the goal of Chris Villeca when he wants his hitters is all about timing, right? Well, Anderson messes with your timing with that leg kick and everything else that he does. And he basically said what Arch said. He said they have to figure out that leg kick and the timing and not get distracted by it.
The 1-1. Rosario spanks one towards center field. Trout won't get it. It'll go to the wall. And Ahmed Rosario into second base. He is going to turn and burn for three, and he is safe with a one-out triple. It's his fourth on the year.
You know, he wasn't going to stop for anybody. With one out, and that ball just shot by Trout out in center field. He plays it. Now watch him. And Rosario said, he was throwing it in when right before he got to second base. And he says, I'm going to third. He wants that triple. There he is. He made his decision. Beats the throw to the base. Now a good chance to score.
Angels bring the infield in, or at least part of the way in. The shortstop, Neto, plays a little deeper than everybody else as Jose Ramirez tries to get Rosario home from third.
Free at bat for Jose right here. And you know, down in their book, they're saying this is a guy, we don't want him to beat us. Although it is only the first inning. And the way they score, I'm sort of a little surprised they have him in.
I tell you, they're not really going to pitch to him. Well, they did. And he sends one to deep center. Trout back on the track up against the wall. He holds on for out number two, and Rosario jogs home with the game's first run. Well, if that's any indication, the ball is jumping tonight. He hit it hard, but Trout looked like that was going to be a routine play until he kissed the wall.
Well, he ran out of room. I'm surprised he didn't get there a little bit quicker. This had some hang time to it, but he gets it right at the wall. He had nowhere else to go. Sacrifice fly. Guardians take a 1-0 lead.
Ten of Jose Ramirez's 21 runs batted in on the year have given the team the lead. That's the most in the American League. Josh Bell had a pitch to Hammer, and he fouled it back. It's 0-2. Right side out of play. Chased one downstairs, and that will end the inning. But an Ahmed Rosario triple leads to the game's first run, 1-0 Cleveland.
Should Viagra really cost $90? We don't think so. RexMD.com has FDA-approved generic Viagra at 90% off with free shipping. Want to know what other guys are saying about RexMD.com?
This was my first time using telemedicine, and I'd recommend this process to anyone. I couldn't be happier with the product.
Visit RexMD.com and fill out a brief survey. If appropriate, you can try generic Viagra for 90% off. Your consultation is free. There's no copays and no doctor office visits. Go to RexMD.com to get started right now.
With ButcherBox, you never have to worry about what's for dinner. We deliver grass-fed beef, organic free-range chicken, humanely raised pork, wild-caught seafood, and so much more. Get high-quality meat sourced from trusted partners with free shipping, always. So you can always be prepared and enjoy the important things. Join ButcherBox today and get 100% grass-fed ground beef free for a year.
Hyundai in the driver's seat. Hunter Renfroe tied for second in the American League in home runs with 10. Shohei Ohtani, Mike Trout right behind him with 8. It's a lineup, as Rick told you, they can mash. They've got 51 homers as a team. That's tied for second in the AL.
Yeah, they're second at 51. And Tampa's 76 home runs they've hit.
They're in another league.
Oh my goodness, it's crazy. And I think the Rosarena just hit one in Yankee Stadium tonight.
That means he's going to get hit again.
Well, he might, but he did the old stance, I think.
He did it again?
Yeah.
Good for him. He did it the last time, and they hit him twice.
He may go down again.
Yeah, looks like another game.
Yeah, I think
I'll
he got Cole on the mound.
Hunter Renfroe is in that same kind of hot zone as Randy Arozarena. 9 hits in his last 9 games. And of those 9 hits, 3 homers, 6 runs driven in. He takes a healthy cut.
Matt, the unbelievable thing is he keeps moving around because he puts up great numbers. He's a really good defensive outfielder with a great arm.
Yeah, he was good in Boston. Yes. Then he went to Milwaukee. And Milwaukee ends up coming over here.
Foul.
He's got good power the other way, too.
Stephen Kwan settling under it. Makes the catch, one down.
Well, the MLB ballpark app allows you to buy and manage game tickets, redeem offers, access exclusive content, and much more. Download the MLB ballpark app today.
Brandon Drury. Boy, this guy had a series in April against Oakland that he'll never forget. In the three games against the A's, he had seven extra base hits and a dozen runs batted in.
Yeah, sounds like a month.
Swung out and missed. It's 1-2.
Good change up.
He went up high with a fastball and struck him out. Two down, second K for Logan Allen.
Batting seventh down for Los Angeles. The first baseman, number 10.
There you go. He elevates the fastball. Gets it around a letter high. He gets him to chase. And you see, Drury took the time out right there. So he was thinking, what do I want to watch? He just swung at a bad changeup out of the zone. So that was a good pitch to follow up on it. And he did chase it.
Two down for Gio Urshela, riding a six-game hitting streak. Ball to strike on the outside corner to even the count. You know, it's interesting. The Angels, you always think about the Angels in pitching, needing more pitching.
Right.
Not enough pitching, right? And yet in the offseason, as Andre alluded to with Hunter Renfroe, they went out and traded for Hunter Renfroe, traded for Gio Urshela, and traded four pitchers away in order to get these two everyday players.
This comes up and get him off the side of the face or bounced off that helmet.
But it sounds like with Phil Nevin, he wanted Gio on his team because of after being in New York and watching him play third base and knowing how versatile he was with the glove and how good a kid he was, he wanted him on his team.
He could play anywhere. He's played all four infield positions.
So I asked him today, I go, your arm hurt now? You're playing first? And he looked at me and he said, it's not where I asked to go. I go where they tell me.
A roller to Jimenez, and he throws out Gio to end the inning. The Angels go in order. It's 1-0 Cleveland.
When it's about to go down,
this is the story of the night.
MLB Tonight takes you there.
We will watch it all together live.
He's done it, 62. How about that?
Big moments.
Oh, baby. 3,000 hits.
Big reactions.
Bobby Witt Jr.'s first big league knock.
And big interviews.
What was the first thing going through your mind?
Join TV's best baseball analysts for a big night of baseball. Every night, only on MLB Network's MLB Tonight.
These new bases are wider than the old ones.
Is he focused on the size of the new bases?
Now it will be easier to steal second base.
Is he thinking about stealing second base?
7 years in the league.
And he's never stolen a single base. Don't steal second base.
The pitcher's not looking.
I am not looking.
Josh Naylor will lead off the home half of the second for Cleveland. Gabriel Arias will follow, then Andrés Giménez. Two out of the three left-handed hitters against the lefty Tyler Anderson.
Yeah, on the year, lefties hitting 207 against Anderson, while righties have a 306 average.
Two balls and a strike. Missed up high. So a good patient approach for Josh Naylor results in a leadoff walk.
Now let's check out the Angels defense now. Brought to you by Rally House. Ward's in left, Trout in center, Renfro over in right. It'll be Rendon at third. Neto is a shortstop, Drury at second, Urshela is at first, and Theis doing the catching.
Gabriel Arias after first pitch changeup fouled it off.
Did it get you, Andre?
Works me good.
Arias has a hit in seven of his last 10 games.
Did hit somebody's head, though.
There goes the runner. Naylor takes off, and he's got an uncontested stolen base.
Wow.
It's his third on the year.
Yeah, you don't pay attention to him. I know he's not a base stealer by trade, but
well, Arch, what does that play into what you said in the open? That with the lefty, sometimes that takes away the run game. Do you think that's something that they're paying attention to? If they've got to be aggressive against certain lefties?
Not with the Naylor.
Soft liner for out.
I mean, you just
one.
Don't expect him to run.
I got you.
You know, he may throw over there when you get somebody else that can do it, but Sandy will have an eye on him.
It's going to bring up Andrés Giménez, and his struggles so far this year have been a mystery. But he's not alone. I'm talking about guys whose batting average is nowhere near what it was a year ago. He's 83 points below where he was last year. Carlos Correa's batting average is 100 points lower than it was a year ago. Among guys on that same list, Jose Abreu, he's down 86 points from last year, and Gene Segura. So you're talking about veteran players.
Yeah, and I mean, Abreu doesn't even have a home run yet this year.
So, Rick, I guess sometimes, you know, maybe as fans, you hear quotes and you think, ah, that's just double talk, that's just cliche. But when guys say that's baseball, there's something more to it than just cliche, isn't there?
Well, every year is different. That is correct. You know, no matter what you do, I mean, I know we always say, reflect back and say, hey, we have the same records we did last year. Well, it's not the same team as last year. We may have some of the same players, but they're off to different starts. You got guys having to come back and do things differently. They're attacking you and pitching you differently, and now it's time for them to make an adjustment.
Oh, and what an adjustment like Andrés Giménez just made. Singling through the left side of the infield, that'll push Josh Naylor over to third base.
You know how
to pick up on your point, Rick. I'm glad you said it that way, because Chris Valleca said, look, we can't keep leaning on excuses like, well, we have the same record as last year, we got off to a slow start as last year.
Right.
He said, we have different expectations, whether that's internal or external, it's different. And so how guys handle that may be affecting them. But he said, we can't worry about that. We've got to put the work in and trust in the process.
Do you know how many times he did that last year? Do you remember how many times he just flipped a ball to left field and took a single instead of maybe trying to turn on it and hit the ball much harder?
And Arch, I can tell you at noon today, they had a machine on getting these guys to push the ball the other way, the lefties that were in the lineup.
Yeah.
All of these guys came in early today after the off day. I was here, as I told you, and that was the first thing Chris said. We're not going to come out here and we're going to try to hit the ball through the roof. We're going to work on hitting the ball the other way.
Take what is given. Mm-hmm. You know, if a pitcher's going to give you maybe a base hit away, and he hit a great pitch, it was down and away. If you do anything but what he did, you're going to hit a roll over on it and hit a ground ball to second base.
And I'm glad you brought that up, Matt, because Chris said that again to me. He said the expectations are not, we don't worry about them outside of the building. Because what I'm worried about is we build expectations amongst ourselves and we're not fulfilling them.
Yeah, they can be a burden if you allow that to happen.
Hey, they're not sneaking up on anybody this year. They did last year because they had so many young players on this ball club. No one knew what to expect. Nobody expected anything.
No.
This year they expect everything.
And Arch Rizzo in the bottom of the first tied the game up in New York with a homer.
Did he?
Yes, he did. It's going to be a fun one there.
The 2-1. Straw sends a high fly ball. This may not be deep enough. Naylor tagging. He's going to try Trout's arm. Here's the throw to the play. And Naylor gets in there safely, but is he okay? That did not look good. He went in with a head first dive into the shin guards of catcher Matt Theiss. He quickly tells Tito, I'm okay. It hurts, but I'm okay. We'll wait and see.
Well, you're right. It wasn't all that deep, and it's a nice one-hop throw, but he goes in head first, and he might have caught that arm or maybe that left shoulder. Watch as he goes into the foot.
Oh, yeah.
There
right
it is,
the
into the shin guard.
Yeah.
Anytime you go head first into home plate and that catcher's got a chance, you're going to run into something very hard, and he certainly did.
Yeah, that didn't feel good. So they'll check him out. Meanwhile, Miles Straw picks up his ninth RBI on the year. Jimenez moves into scoring position on the throw. But Gallagher grounds out to end the inning. Guardians have scored one in the first two, and their lead is 2-0 on a daring slide by Josh Naylor.
Wake up to baseball's biggest stories.
Robert Flores wearing tweed.
Wake up to big name guests.
Very special guests hanging out on the crushed red velvet.
This show is tough to get ready for.
And wake up to a whole lot of fun.
Wearing a robe holding a wooden phone.
MLB Central.
It is absolutely hilarious.
The show baseball fans
and baseball players
wake up to.
Show's starting to pick up.
I love the energy. I love the unexpected performances.
Weekday mornings on MLB Network.
We'll have a little fun and we'll laugh.
Think baseball.
There's something that's been missing in the debate.
Think analysis.
Now he goes into his contract year. What do you do with this guy?
Think advanced metrics.
The new rules are having an impact, and I'll bottom line it.
Think MLB Now, the show for the thinking fan. Only on MLB Network.
Now begin with just 15 games and are on sale for just a few more days. You can all plans feature discounted tickets and a flexible exchange program. 216-420-HITS.
Angels catcher Matt Theiss. He went hitless in his first five games, and since then he's hit .412.
Yeah, they got a couple catchers on the IL. Stassi, Chad Wallach. So they're carrying two right now that are just trying to bide some time.
Yeah, Chris Oakey just made his Angels debut on Tuesday. He's the other catcher right now. Pate, outside corner. Two is slapped the other way and foul. And we'll get a word right now from Spectrum One.
Spectrum One is fast, secure, and reliable. Internet for $49.99 a month. Free advanced Wi-Fi and a free mobile line. Restrictions apply. Visit Spectrum.com for details.
That one fair.
That was a good swing. He did the same thing that Jimenez did, except he hit his a little harder, but he stayed right on it. It's down, it's away, and stays through the, look at that, kept the head right there and let it get deep in the zone. And there's a lot of room over on that side of the field. That one was a line drive. The foul ball was upstairs a little bit. He was a little bit out in front.
Here is 22-year-old Zach Neto. Neto was the 13th overall pick in the draft last year. The Angels are hoping that he can solve their shortstop dilemma. They've had four different players start games at shortstop this year. Between Gio Urshela, David Fletcher, Luis Ranjifo. Remember Andrew Velasquez? He started 100 games last year.
Yeah.
He didn't even make the club out of spring training this year.
How about this guy? Doesn't look very big at all, but he's been hit by pitches seven times already this year. Look at that high leg kick.
He got hit by a pitch in four straight games back in April. Must be one of those guys like Jimenez where he just doesn't move.
Yeah, watch how high his front leg goes on his kick. Can't get out of the way.
Center field, Miles Straw. One down.
Check it out. Watch how long this thing hangs up in the air. Holy smokes.
It's like a pitcher's
elbow.
Almost looks like a pitcher, you know, when he's coming back and
playing wiffle ball.
One on, one out, Taylor Ward. Up the middle and through. And stopping at second base is Matt Price. Angels have two on with one out on a seeing eye single by Taylor Ward.
Well, right there, that's probably the difference in the shifting now, where you can't put another guy over the shortstop on that side. A great attempt there by Jimenez. But you see, it's on the shortstop side. He just couldn't get there. And if he did, I don't think he was going to be able to do anything with it.
Almost looked like for a split second, Logan Allen thought about making a play on it and decided to let it go through, thinking maybe there was a defender right behind him. Don't know if he could have made the play anyway. Mike Trout takes a breaking ball for a strike. Trout popped up on the infield his first time up. Did he go? No. Off to the right and out of play. Keeping it in on him.
I love it. And he just went fastball away there. This is one of the few guys that can go out there and pitch inside. He has to. You know, Matt, he's got to use both sides of that plate with that changeup and the breaking ball. But he jammed him the first time up. He had a little flare to the second baseman. Just make sure you get it in there. That's all.
Oh, it's a just barely a foul ball.
That's a break.
That'll send the runners back. This is where the Angels are always dangerous this year. So far, I mean, that was less than a foot. They're batting 276 as a team with runners in scoring position.
Well, that's how you score a lot of runs. That's something that we've got to start doing now. Hit with runners in scoring position. Get the hits when you need them.
Oh, he got him. Oh, they said he didn't go.
Well, let's take a look at, from the side. We'll see what you think. Call a game, not the name.
2-2. Mike Trout is making Logan Allen work hard for it, and he's got Shohei Ohtani waiting on deck. This will be the eighth pitch of the at bat.
Yeah, he's got a good one going right now. A good at bat. We can get him a ground ball.
Swing and a miss. He just reared back and pumped the fastball by him. Third strikeout of the night for Logan Allen.
Well, great clip. This is going to be great. Watch the sequence. There he starts him off, breaking ball for strike one. Another one, miss, fastball away. Goes in and jams him, in and jams him. Tried to go down and in. Fouled one off and then went right back, Keeter, on the inner part of the plate. And it was up high enough to get it by him. Very good.
Good fastball in tight for strike one. He went right back in there and blew it by him. It's 0-2, and Ohtani says, I need a timeout.
He's making some really good pitches on the inside part of the plate to the good hitters, the big guys that like to extend the arms. He's gone inside, and his control has been very good.
Two on, two out, two strike pitch. Couldn't get him to chase. Go fish. Back to back strikeouts of Trout and Ohtani with two men on base here in the third. This is some great pitching by Logan Allen.
And coverage all day, every day, your way on MLB Network. This is Chris Bryant. This is Christopher Russo. And this is the High Heat Hot Seat. Chris Bryant plays hard so he doesn't end up here. High Heat with Christopher Russo, helping players play harder on MLB Network.
Tonight is Asian American and Pacific Islander Celebration Night here at Progressive Field. And Dre, you talked to Stephen Kwan in spring training about his connection to Ichiro. You want to relay that story?
I think it's a great story as he takes the first pitch. No surprise there. You know, for Stephen Kwan, he said growing up, they really never saw another player playing baseball that looked like him. So his grandmother would watch games, and Seattle games end up being the games they would watch because Ichiro. As he drives this ball, not going to get all the way out of here, but Ichiro is a player that he watched, and he grew up, and when he got to meet him last year in Seattle, the only thing he wanted to tell him was that you were my grandmother's favorite player, you're my favorite player, and thank you for giving me someone that I could look at, that I could say, hey, I can be a big league ball player, and he says that's always going to be the motivation for him, knowing when he comes to the ballpark to play, there may be a little kid out there that looks like him that, you know, doesn't have another player to look at that looks like him, and he wants to play well and play hard to let a kid know that they can make it just like he did, because that's what Ichiro did for him.
Yeah, you know, good a guy story. Like Ichiro, as great a player as he was, probably didn't have any idea the impact he had culturally on kids growing up here in America watching him play.
And you don't think about that unless you are, you know, those guys. He said he would go to San Francisco Giant games. He would watch Raj Davis and players like that. But it was Ichiro that made him fall in love with the game of baseball.
Yeah, what a player, too.
Yeah, not a bad one to watch, right?
You're going to watch. Why not watch one of the best?
Watch the best.
That's pretty good.
And that's why it was so cool when we went to Seattle last year. Remember, they were putting Ichiro in their Walk of Fame or Hall of Fame there. And he said, I was a fan. He goes, everybody's getting ready for the game. And he goes, I'm sitting there thinking, this is my whole childhood right here. Ooh.
Ahmed able to dance out of the way. He had a triple his first time up. Smoked one to center field. It got by Trout.
Might be the gloves, Matt. Got the yellow gloves on tonight. But he's ready. He's, you know, the frustration of the first month or so, he's, you know, like everyone else, he wanted to have a good start to this season. He was frustrated that he wasn't good enough. And now he's back in that rhythm of, okay, it's May. It's time to play.
He and Bobby Witt Jr. of the Royals tied for the league lead now with four triples. We know one thing about Ahmed. He gets a hit early.
Yeah, he adds on.
Six hits now in his last 12 at-bats on the homestand. And a bullet to second caught by
Drury. All right. Good at-bat. Very good at-bat.
Let's check out our Spectrum mobile replay. Watch this again back in the first inning. Nothing more fun than a triple.
That ball shot by Trout out there.
And then Jose Ramirez brought him home with a deep fly ball that Mike Trout ran smack dab into the wall. And there's a line drive left center. That's going to split him. And that'll be extra bags for Jose Ramirez. It's his 10th double on the year, first to double figures in that category for Cleveland.
Yeah, gave him a little swinging room right there. Watch, he left it down out over the plate to change up, and he just smoked it. He stayed back, and I'm sure Jose's probably looking a lot of off-speed pitches. He may show him a fastball, but I don't think he wants to throw him for strikes. Well, the third hit now for the Guardians.
Nothing new for Jose Ramirez since the start of 2020. That is his 200th extra base hit. And that is the most in the majors. Think about that. We always talk about the big players, the star players. Jose has more extra base hits than anybody since 2020.
Well, he turned singles into doubles and always has.
And here's Josh Bell on a 3-0 count. He's already walked eight times in his last nine games. He'll make it nine walks now in his last 10.
Well, he didn't want much to do there.
FanDuel same game parlay. Logan Allen already has four strikeouts. They like the over there. Ahmed Rosario already in the books with a hit, and Jose Ramirez with an RBI. So one more strikeout from Logan Allen makes that a winning parlay. Two on, two out. Josh Naylor to the plate. He walked, stole a base, scored on the sac fly by Straw. Got up and was in pain, but true to Josh Naylor form, did not leave the game. There's that arm with the sleeve on it. Looked like it just slammed right into the shin guards of catcher Matt Theiss. Up the middle, will it get through? Oh my goodness, what a carom. Right to the second baseman Drury to retire the side. No runs, a hit, two left. We've played three, 2-0 Cleveland.
You want highlights? Quick Pitch has you covered. Packing all the day's biggest plays into one lightning fast hour.
What a play!
We live today, preview tomorrow on Quick Pitch. Late nights and every morning, only on MLB Network.
An 04 champ.
Well, hello.
A 2013 champ.
This is going to be fun. Let's get it on.
And a host who keeps them both in check.
Players know who you guys are, right?
Intentional Talk on MLB Network.
2023, welcome to the show.
This is the game we all want to see.
Batting averages are up this year.
Pitch clock has really made a difference.
And so are runs.
He scores.
What a stolen base.
With the shift, you never saw these plays.
Guys seem more ready.
Athleticism is back in baseball.
The pace, the action.
So much quicker, so much crisper.
And this game is over.
It's the best game in the world. Now it's even better.
Nothing. Guardians on top, fourth inning. Anthony Rendon, Hunter Renfro, and Brandon Drury for the Angels. A warm Friday night here at Progressive Field. Boy, what a night. 70 degrees at game time.
That's why we see that ball doing, maybe carrying a little bit better than normal.
Yeah, what, isn't it amazing what a difference it makes when you don't have that wind whipping off
yeah.
the lake and not
right, and it's not cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. It makes the world of difference.
Anthony Rendon juices one deep left center field and off the wall, played well by Straw, but Rendon is already at second base with a leadoff double.
Well, Rendon in his first at bat shot him to right field and hit it pretty good. That's when I says, boy, the ball's carrying pretty well. But he gets underneath this one and he gets that spin on it where it's going to carry. You can see he stayed down and threw it, and it just misses getting out of here for a home run. You can see Straw played it perfectly. It didn't matter. He was cruising around anyway. That ball was hit very high.
Now Hunter Renfro. And he goes after the first pitch and pops it up. Jimenez. One down. Our Miller Lite moment back in the third. Two on. One out. You got Mike Trout at the plate first.
Yeah, what are you going to do? He's gotten ahead of him both times with strike one, and now he's going to stay inside on him to get it. He missed it and then fouled one off, and he's going to get a fastball in there. And with Ohtani, same thing. Strike one, stayed in there. He's making these hitters conscious inside is what he's doing. That's exactly what he did with Renfro. Here's a guy, right-hander, likes to go the other way with the bat. You got a man on second base. He jammed him. He popped it up to the infield.
Mm-hmm.
You got to pitch into the hitters, especially when you have guys in scoring position, because most of them will look away.
But as you have said time and time again, as that ball's hammered down the left field line, Brandon Drury got to it, and he's going to drive home the Angels' first run of the night. Cuts the lead in half at 2-1. Drury RBI number 21. he did a nice job of getting to it.
Yeah, it was upstairs, and it didn't quite get in where you wanted it. And Drury, a guy that he could put, he got on top of that one. That's not an easy thing to do, but he did it. Get the base hit, give him credit. He gets his 21st RBI.
What I was going to say, though, is for a pitcher to pitch inside, you have to be able to pitch inside four strikes.
Yeah, you got to prove you can throw him for strikes, correct. You can't just throw them inside and back them off and say, okay, let me go back out away. You've got to prove you can throw it for strikes in there, because you'll see him that first time. This is the first time they faced him, so they don't know any better. They don't know he's going to be pitching inside, but you watch the second time through. They've got three hits. They got one the first time through, and we'll see what happens if he can get and go through the third time, because now they'll have a better game plan for him.
Gio Urshela grounded out his first time up. 4 times this year he's had at least 3 hits in a game.
He's turning into a singles hitter. He shoots it the other way. He tried to do the first time up.
Look at that. That's going to split him, and this could be trouble. Straw slides, cuts it off. Into third, they're going to wave him home.
Got a throw.
Here's the throw from Jimenez, and they got him.
Again, going in head first, he tried to get that hand to the back part of the plate. Did Gallagher get him before that hand touched the plate? We are going to find out, because they are going to challenge. It looked like his hand might have gotten in. I don't know. It was close. And you see Straw coming up, making another one. That little bobble there, and I shouldn't say that because it may have cost him, but did the hand get in? That's close. He was called out, so can we prove it? Oh, yes. I think the hand got to the plate before the tag was applied. Boy, was that close. What a great relay. Anyway, sliding down to cut the ball, get it to Jimenez. They make this throw, and it looked like he was starting trying to bobble that ball, but there's the hand. You can see he gets to the plate.
What? He didn't even have the ball in the glove. The ball was in his bare hand, and so that may have cost him anyway.
Yeah.
Just couldn't get the quite. Feel for
you know, when you're looking for that ball coming like from right center field, you had to have two hands on it, and you're right, it was in his bare hand. Good call. Wasn't even in the glove.
After review, the call on the field is overturned. The runner is safe. Los Angeles retains their challenge.
So Gio Urshela gets his 13th run batted in on the year, and that ties the game at 2.
Now batting for the Angels after
that's the third hit in the inning, second double in the inning, and we have a new ball game.
Matt Theis single to left, his first time up. A breaking ball and a
big swing and a miss, 1-1.
Theis, the first time he took what was given. He had a nice line drive to left field.
Strike. Just missed outside. Ball 4. Second walk issued by Logan Allen on the night. And that's going to bring out Carl Willis. That's the 4th Angel to reach here in the 4th inning. And we'll get a word right now from Cleveland Clinic.
Get the care you need when and where you need it. Visit clevelandclinic.org/access. Cleveland Clinic is proud to be the official healthcare provider of the Cleveland Guardians.
You know, Matt, Rick, I know ball players have long memories and don't forget things. Last year, when Chris Drury was playing for the Cincinnati Reds, there was a ball that was hit up the middle, and Miles Straw picked it up and threw Drury out at third base. He was coming from first base, and Miles said to me, he goes, Drury's a good player. He goes, but I know he doesn't run that well. And he goes, so I kind of deked him and kind of came up slow on the ball, and I got him at third. He goes, but I know because that happened, he'll never run slow on me again. And what happens tonight? Drury coming from first base scores from first base.
You know, and I don't mean this by any slight for Miles. When he slid to get that ball, he did a tremendous job. But it went in the transfer for about a half a step. I think, you know, it took him to get rid of it.
I guarantee,
it was a terrific play.
I guarantee Miles will say the same thing, Arch.
Back out of play. Zach Neto fly to center first time up.
But we've watched Miles do that a ton of times where we think a ball's going to get all the way to the wall, and he cuts it off with that slide.
He just plays the wall, and I don't care what ballpark you're in, so perfectly. You know, where other guys, it seems like they've never been in that ballpark before.
In off the plate, 1-1.
Well, as you know, a lot of people aren't comfortable when they get close to that wall. They feel that dirt and become a different guy.
Well, that's why the dirt's there. But you got to play back off the wall sometimes and let it come back to you, and don't overrun it.
In the hole, base hit. Go ahead, run around third. Urshela to the plate. The throw is not there, and everybody moves up, and it's 3-2 Angels. Fourth hit in the inning. And Zach Neto has his ninth run batted in.
Well, found the hole right there. I didn't think that by the time that got out there, it wasn't hit all that hard, that they were going to have a chance to get Urshela. And then the other two are going to move up.
Back to the top of the order, Taylor Ward. Still only one out. Logan Allen's got to find a way to get himself out of this jam now. And Ward singled right up the middle in the third inning to third base this time.
Oh, here is that's a nice job.
Almost had
running.
Himself a double play, but alertly Feist got back to the
Yeah, play. That's really a good job of base running. Because sometimes you see that ball coming at you, your instincts, you want to go to home plate. But thank God he's a catcher for the Angels. He got back, so you just take the out at first base. But what an adjustment they made that second time through the lineup against Logan Allen. Five hits. He had one the first time through.
And now Mike Trout. And fastball strike. He went right at him. Action in the Cleveland bullpen. Xavier Curry getting loose, and a soft liner will end the inning. The Angels turn the tables on the Guardians here in the fourth. They now lead it 3-2.
The next generation of baseball has arrived.
And I am here for it.
Keep an eye on the new faces of baseball on Off Base, the modern baseball show for the modern baseball fan.
It's all about things you haven't seen before.
Only on MLB Network. Watch games and coverage all day, every day, your way on MLB Network.
from four different theme packs, including weekends, and new this year, a six pack in the Discount Drug Mart club seats.
Gabriel Arias leading off for the Guardians here in the fourth. Lined out to the third baseman Anthony Rendon, his first time up. Out of play. Up shallow center, Drury, the second baseman, goes out to get it. One down. Check out our Bounty quick stats. And the Angels, second best team in the American League when it comes to bombing away. Drag bone attempt. Nobody's home, and it'll be an infield single for Andrés Giménez.
Well, Urshela got faked out. He didn't realize that Anderson was going to be able to catch that ball. And that's your job. And if the pitcher gets it, then you just, you know, normally you just try to beat it, beat him to the bag, but he caught it, so Urshela made a mistake.
Not a natural first baseman. And you joked about it earlier, but that's obviously one of those plays that if you don't play there all the time, it's probably very awkward. And didn't I just say to you a day ago, we haven't seen him try to bunt in a while as he's been struggling, but he gets a hit, then he comes back and gets one.
Well, he went the other way. He's now 2-for-2.
Miles Straw to short. Neto to second to get the force on the lead runner. And there are two down for Cam Gallagher.
Quick pitch there.
Smoked foul over the head of Mike Sarbaugh, the third base coach. Yeah, get down quick, Sarby. Cam Gallagher's two hits on the year have come against the AL West. One against Seattle, one against Oakland. Up shallow center, in comes Mike Trout, and the inning is over. Four complete. It's the Angels 3 and the Guardians 2.
Create amazing work with Fiverr. All you need is your team and a talented freelancer who will lend a hand and seamlessly join your team from just about anywhere. Expand your team with a Fiverr freelancer.
Sure, you'll teach her to drive a car. Then use Greenlight and teach her to save up for her own car. Mowing lawns and getting paid. Navigate the world of earning, saving, and investing together. Invest in your best investment. Greenlight.
ED is difficult for me and for my partner. Through HIMSS, I can message a licensed provider about clinically proven ED treatments. Like the generic form of Viagra, which can cost 90% less than the brand name version. Then HIMSS ships discreetly to my door for free. I never knew it could be this easy to get my confidence back. Now we can both count on a great experience every time. Start your free visit today at forhims.com.
Cleveland Guardians baseball brought to you by Levin. Buy it today, sleep on it tonight. And by Spectrum One. Visit Spectrum.com for details. Shohei Ohtani leads off the fifth inning and takes a breaking ball for a strike.
That's the one thing that Allen has done well to the middle part of this lineup is get ahead of these guys. Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't want to have to make your living pitching from behind
right.
against guys like Trout,
yeah,
Ohtani, Rendon.
They cut down that their strike zone and they zone into their nitro zones.
Gets the benefit of the doubt on the 2-2. That's off the plate, full count. Swing and up.
Oh, he got a piece of it.
Oh, he got the Gallagher's glove.
You know,
got the bat of Ohtani.
The way he stands there, you can tell. I mean, he turns. And it looks like he's got that long swing. I mean, just the way his stance is. Look how far back that bat is. And it comes by late. And that was a perfect pitch. But he did get a piece of the glove.
This happens a lot with him. Of the last 19 times catcher's interference has been called in a major league game, Ohtani has been the batter four times. Now you can make it the last 20. Five of them have been
Ohtani. Okay, so 20%. You've got to know that as a catcher.
Yeah.
You've got to know that.
It's obviously how deep he is and how late he swings. It's something that happens a lot.
Number six, Anthony Rendon.
So Ohtani reaching on catcher's interference instead of an out. Logan Allen is right back in the barrel. Outside.
Yeah, this is the guy, you know, he's going to be careful with because he almost hit one out of here in his last at bat to left center field. So he's trying to make a perfect pitch but hasn't done it yet.
What? smoked. And Straw plays on a couple of hops. Ohtani stops at second base. And the Angels.
Well, Rendon gets a 3-1 fastball, but this one was down a little bit. And you can see that had a lot of the plate. And what's he do? What you're supposed to. Hit a line drive. And he did. That ball hit just a two hopper to Straw. So Ohtani's not going to take a chance. He's going to stay right there.
That's seven hits in the last three innings now for the Angels. With Logan Allen, once again, the bullpen will get busy. Hunter Renfro 0 for 2 on the night. This fly to left popped up on the infield. He went around. 1-1. We mentioned early that when you play the Angels, you have to bring the offense because it's a club that can put up some runs. They've scored four runs or more 24 times already this year, and they're 16-8 in those games.
Well, the one thing, though, they never play well in this ballpark, or at least as far as the outcome comes.
It's going to drop for a hit, and the bases are loaded.
Well, not a good way to start this fifth inning. But if Sandlin's ready, I'm thinking he might be about done.
Going to get Carl Willis to come out.
That jammed him. He didn't get enough of it. He's pitched him inside twice today. He didn't get enough of it, so it's going to fall as a hit. So they just move up 90 feet. And now it's time to minimize the damage in this inning, that's for sure.
Well, while they talk things over, we'll get a Ken Ganley Kia game break with Al Pawlowski.
All right, Matt, Art, Jandre, let's head to New York. Yankees hosting the Rays. Garrett Cole on the hill for the Yankees, and Jose Siri getting the best of him right here. His fourth home run of the season. That's a solo shot. Breaks a 1-1 tie. 2-1, Tampa Bay leads New York. They're in the bottom of the fifth at Yankee Stadium, fellas.
So that's what, 78 home runs?
Yeah, it sure is.
78 home runs for the Rays, and the Angels are the second best home run hitting team in the league, and they have 51. So the bases are loaded, nobody out. Brandon Drury steps in and goes after the first pitch, breaking ball down and in.
That's good. He helped him out. He was going to guess fastball right there and try and shoot him.
And it's 0-2. The Angels came in one of the best hitting teams, not only with runners in scoring position, but also in bases loaded situations. Third best mark in the majors, batting .406 as a team. He got him to chase and strikes him out for his fifth strikeout of the night.
Yeah, he got him to chase it. Two pitches in that sequence there. The first one and the last one. He went out of the zone, and out comes Tito because he's had enough. Now he needs a double play ball.
So We've got a timeout with the bases loaded and one out in the fifth, and the Angels leading it 3-2.
Take control of your health by boosting your force field, the immune system. With the Aura Ring, you can listen to your body's signals and raise your defenses. Aura tells you when your temperature is higher than normal, how to improve your sleep, or if your heart rate shows signs of stress, so you can decide to push yourself or to lie low. Live smarter, stronger, healthier with the Aura Ring.
When the details take precedence, the rest falls perfectly into place. We strip away everything but the essential, and what we're left with are thoughtful bedrooms for modern living. Thuma.
We love going to games, but good seats get pricey. So we use Game Time. Game Time tracks ticket prices in real time and finds you all the best last minute deals. We got our seats 20 minutes ago for 60% off. Last minute tickets at the best price in seconds. Download Game Time now.
FanDuel customers get $150 in bonus bets on your first $5 bet. Download the FanDuel app and make every move a moment more. So coming on now,
Cleveland Clinic call to the bullpen for Nick Sandlin. Welcome to the game. Yeah. You know, go get him, right? Bases loaded.
Well, yes, he's looking for a ground ball here. And Gio, he will try and shoot him again to right field. You know, so that's going to be a big pitch for him in that bat right there. He's got to control that slider.
Trying to give him a chase, nothing doing.
There's one on to first. They turn an inning ending double play. Nick Sandlin gets the twofer, and the Guardians get out of a major jam here in the fifth.
When it's about to go down,
this is the story of the night.
MLB Tonight takes you there.
You will watch it all together live.
He's done it 62. That.
Big moments.
Oh, baby. 3,000 hits.
Big reactions.
Bobby Witt Jr.'s first big league knock.
And big interviews.
What was the first thing going through your mind?
Join TV's best baseball analysts for a big night of baseball. Every night, only on MLB Network's MLB Tonight.
2023, welcome to the show.
This is the game we all want to see.
Batting averages are up this year.
Pitch clock has really made a difference.
And so are runs.
He scores. What a stolen base.
With the shift, he never saw these plays.
Guys seem more ready.
Athleticism is back in baseball.
The pace, the action.
So much quicker, so much crisper.
And this game is over.
It's the best game in the world. Now it's even better.
Raffle presented by Bally Sports Great Lakes is open and it runs through May 28th. You can visit cleguardians.com/5050 for your chance to win.
Top of the order, Stephen Kwan leading off. He was going to try to bunt. Took it high for ball one. 1-0-2 on the night. Boy, that could be a huge turning point in this game. Guardians getting out of a bases loaded. Nobody out jam. Against one of the best hitting teams in the business this year with the bases loaded. Tyler Anderson, meanwhile, allowed a run in the first, one in the second. Had two base runners on, but they both reached after there were two outs in the third. He got out of that.
Foul tip. Well, you don't see a swing like that from Kwan very often.
Guardians have had a hit in every inning.
Just a little inside. Right off the bat as he moved that bat a little too much.
Anderson has walked two on the night. And now he's walked his third. The leadoff man is aboard. That's the tying run here in the fifth. Kwan has stolen 8 out of 9 on the year. And the Guardians saw Josh Naylor steal second base uncontested in the second inning after he led off with a walk. But it's not easy to run when you've got Ahmed Rosario at the plate because he's looking to swing.
Yeah, and as a base stealer, you got to get a look at that move if you haven't been on, except for the first time, to pick something up. Sandy can tell you what to look for.
Rosario with a rifle shot into right field. That's his second hit of the night. Kwan stops at second, and here come the Guardians.
And he could have three because he hit it right on the nose and lined out to second base.
Northern Ohio Buick Dealers Stat Guardians all-time hit list. Jose Ramirez occupies the 20th spot, just one behind Dr. Styx. Or rather, Dr. Smooth. Excuse me.
Too many doctors on this team.
Apologies to Tristan McKenzie. Yeah. Well, Michael Brantley is next, and then you've got Carlos Santana. Well,
I don't know who you should apologize to, Brantley or.
Apologies to Michael.
I got a feeling I'm going to get a text from both of them. Put it that way. Yeah. I've been trying to get Brantley to tell me when he's coming back. Now I know he'll call me. By the way, Tristan's doing really well. Threw 30 pitches yesterday. He's going to fly into Tennessee tonight to go to his brother's graduation from college. Then we will see him here either at the end of the weekend or maybe in Chicago. Then Archie's going to go to Akron or to Columbus, and he's going to start and getting ready to ramp up to get ready to come here.
Good news.
All is good with him. Dr. Styx or Dr. Smooth. He's ready.
Dr. Smooth Styx.
Jose Ramirez almost got hit on the back foot. Action in the Angels bullpen. Chris Davinsky getting loose. Tyler Anderson's only made 69 pitches. Jose, a big rip at that cutter. Knocked in the first run of the night with a sacrifice fly. He doubled with two outs in the third. Outfield straight up deep. Boy, he got away with
two healthy hacks right there, but now let's see if he shortens up. He hit the changeup last time, and I mean drilled it for a double.
One in the air to right. Renfro makes the catch. Quan will tag and move to third. So the tying run 90 feet away now for Josh Bell. At least it's a productive out for Jose. And Josh Bell has struck out and walked on the night. Ball to third. They go to second and they just do get the force. Although Ahmed Rosario pointed to the dugout, he felt like maybe he beat the play. Regardless, we are tied at three. Give Josh Bell his 17th run batted in on the year.
Well, he felt he had more time there at second base.
That's hard to tell on that look, and the Guardians are not going to challenge.
No, that's right. They're not. You'll see it from this angle, maybe a little better. It's close, awfully close.
So there are two down. It's a 3-3 game. Josh Naylor. Taylor caught a bad break last time up with two on a two out. He hit a ball up the middle. It hit the side of the mound, or maybe it deflected off the pitcher. And it went right to the second baseman, Drury. And they were able to get out of the inning. Check again. We never got a second look at this.
I thought we got the pitcher. Let me see.
I don't think he ever touched it. It just perfectly caromed right to Drury. One ball, two strikes. Set up for that pitch. You're talking about missing your target by a lot. That's way outside, full count. But for a catcher, your heart probably skips a beat when you're set up away and you start drifting that glove back over the plate.
Yeah. Yeah, this is a guy that, you know, he doesn't know, he's not over parring. He's got to hit his spots. If he gets ahead of you, he'll try and get you to chase.
That's a fair ball behind the bag. Urshela takes it himself. Guardians come back and tie the game.
'23, welcome to the show.
This is the game we all want to see.
Batting averages are up this year.
Pitch clock has really made a difference.
And so are runs.
He scores. What a stolen base.
With the shift, he never saw these plays.
Guys seem more ready.
Athleticism is back in baseball.
The pace, the action.
So much quicker, so much crisper.
And this game is over.
It's the best game in the world. Now it's even better.
You want highlights? Quick Pitch has you covered. Packing all the day's biggest plays into one lightning-fast hour.
What a play!
We live today, preview tomorrow on Quick Pitch. Late nights and every morning, only on MLB Network.
The series continues tomorrow evening. We've got a 6 o'clock game, so Guardians Live pregame begins our coverage at 5:30 with Al Pulaski and Chris Jimenez. Now talk to Reed Detmers to match up tomorrow night. Nick Sandlin got that double play ball to get out of the fifth. He'll stay on to pitch the sixth. Matt Feist leading it off, has singled and walked. Center field, Straw going back. All into the warning track for out number one. Injury report brought to you by the attorneys at Elk and Elk.
Stepping in now.
Max Fried and Kyle Wright both expected to miss anywhere from 1 to 2 months of action for Atlanta. Braves with a 6.5 game lead over the Marlins in the NL East.
Oh my goodness. Check swing, easy out.
Two down. Yeah, the Braves lead the Marlins by 6.5 games. Who had Miami in second place?
Right.
2 weeks into May. Philadelphia is in third place. They're just a half game behind Miami. Then the Mets are in fourth place, 2 games under .500. They have lost 5 consecutive series, and we'll see the Mets in New York on the next road trip.
Yeah, you look at them and the Yankees, the teams in New York that have been struggling. The Yankees are over the .500 mark, though.
But they find themselves in the cellar in the very competitive AL East.
Yeah, but you know what, Matt? When you bring up the NL East, the team that I look at is Philadelphia. After the run they had last year, they just can't find their footing as well right now in that division.
Now ball to second, and Jimenez throws him out. Nick Sandler. Sharp tonight.
See it.
He struck him out. It's out of here.
Feel it.
I can't wait for this game to start.
He took a home run away.
Live it.
That is as good as it gets.
Oh, the big plays.
The beauty of sports is when the hero comes through.
Yeah, the tense moments.
We have an update. We must show you.
With live look-ins, highlights, and breakdowns.
That might be what it takes to win.
MLB Tonight on MLB Network.
Hey fans, I'm breaking down MLB Play. I think they're the best MLB games. Now my personal favorite, Beat the Streak. Pick who you'll think will get a hit, building your own streak. It's all on you, baby. You can win 5.6 million bucks. The streak's alive! Next up, Pickle. Guess the player in the fewest number of tries. Got him! And there's other games like Bingo, a race to be first. Bingo! MLB Play. Great games, great prizes, and it's all free. No purchase necessary. Restrictions apply. See official rules and enter at MLB.com/play. Oh yeah!
This is Chris Bryant. This is Christopher Russo. And this is the High Heat Hot Seat. Chris Bryant plays hard so he doesn't end up here. High Heat with Christopher Russo, helping players play harder on MLB Network.
Tyler Anderson back out here for the bottom of the sixth inning. He's allowed 3 runs on 5 hits. He has walked 3. 2 of those walks have come around to score against him. He's only struck out 1 batter. Guardians have 1 hit in every inning thus far. Gabriel Arias 0-for-2 leads off. Thank you. field near the line. Renfro makes the catch. One away. Well, these two teams are in familiar territory as we take a look at our Medical Mutual five-star report. Guardians lead the way. They played 17 one-run games, and the Angels aren't far behind.
Sounds like we've been saying that for quite some time now. One-run games.
First pitch strike to Andrés Giménez. He flipped one into left field in the second inning for a base hit, then a drag bunt single in the fourth. Check up for Cleveland. Angels bullpen, they have a right-hander up. He dropped down sidearm a little bit with that delivery.
Yeah, he threw one, was it last inning to a left-hander, or the inning before? No, it was Kwan. He tried to get him.
3-1 pitch, and Giménez pops to left. Two down. Tyler Anderson, I mentioned, has walked three. Two of those came around to score. Both times it was when he walked the leadoff man. His last start against Texas, he walked a season high five batters in that game and gave up five hits. So the fact that he only gave up two earned runs,
yeah,
three total against that Rangers lineup, despite that many base runners, is pretty impressive.
Well, he's walked three. You mentioned it, and they scored a pair today. Two of them the walks have scored.
But you can see, Rick, he's the kind of left-hander that can really frustrate a lineup.
If you chase after his pitches, you have got to really remain disciplined, because if you chase any of his stuff, he doesn't want to throw you a strike. I mean, he just, that fastball he throws where he was giving up a 350 average, he's either going to try to elevate it or make perfect pitches, or then just attack you with the little cutter, change-ups, and off-speed pitches, trying to get you to get yourself out.
Yeah, go back to that last at bat at Giménez. It's a 3-1 count. You're expecting him maybe to challenge you to some degree, and no, he'd rather walk you. It might have been a strike, but it wasn't a pitch for Giménez that he could really get into.
Let's see what he does here with Straw when he was up 0-2. Just ball. See, he went down and he got a base hit, and he hit a pitch out of the zone. I'll tell you that.
Straw hit second, and he thought about it, but he wisely holds with a two-out double. He's in scoring position. No reason to push it there.
I'll tell you what, Straw did a good job. He hit that. That was not a strike.
That was down.
Yeah, it was below the strike zone, but look at him go get it. And then he can drive it to right field. A lot of times you'll see Miles swinging the pitches upstairs that you can't get on top of. He was able to get on top of that ball and hit a line drive. He's trying to look for that pitch down more.
Yeah, well, that's what you've always talked about. When guys are throwing your pitches high, you got to force them to go down. But I can tell you two guys that thought he should have went to third. They're right next to me.
Oh, yeah.
The extra third base coaches.
Well, they wanted him to go to third. And if he got thrown out, they'd be yelling at him.
It's kind of like working with you.
Yes, indeed. I'm
right,
going to yell anyway.
Look at them. They're both.
If you can get there with one out and you can get there, it's maybe worth a gamble. But with two outs, you're already in scoring position. You can't get thrown out of third.
He made the right decision. But I know for these guys over here, they've talked about being aggressive, being
that's
smart.
That's their nature.
Yes,
man, I mean, they're
absolutely
aggressive when they wake up in the morning.
And Med said he went after his on purpose. He wanted to tell these guys it's time to go. That's why he did it in the first inning.
They haven't made enough left-hand turns to have the confidence yet.
0-2 to Gallagher.
I know Miles wanted to because he hit the brakes after he already decided to.
Cam Gallagher late entry into the starting lineup. Originally, Mike Zunino was in the starting lineup, but he was scratched with some neck soreness. And a bouncing ball in the hole, backhanded by Neto. His throw is on the money. Six complete, deadlocked at three. Cleveland Guardians baseball brought to you by Chevrolet. Check out their award-winning lineup at your local Chevy dealer. Union Home Mortgage, promises kept. And by SumaCare, build your own medical advantage plan with SumaCare. Call or go online today. Well, 3-3 our score. And we're coming down the stretch. Seventh inning, James Karinchak. On the pitch after Nick Sandlin gave him an inning and two-thirds of perfect relief.
Yeah, he did a great job tonight.
Karinchak will have the big boys, Mike Trout, Shohei Ohtani, and Anthony Rendon. You can't assume he's taken all the way, but you sure hope he is when you throw one down the middle, right?
Well, you have to get a strike. You don't want to walk him. He's not going to run anywhere. He hasn't attempted a stolen base, but you got to make him hit his way on. And then he went with the curveball, so he finally got one down in the zone.
For the best coverage in the game, let's check out the T-Mobile coverage cam. Nick Sandlin came into a bases loaded one out jam. Got a double play ball to end the inning.
Boy, and that's and then he goes out the next inning and has an easy 1-2-3 fly ball to center, ground ball to third, and a 4-3. Sandlin did an outstanding job. And that's after, in that inning before Sandlin came in, that Allen was able to get the strikeout with the bases loaded on Drury. And then they get the double play. They had bases loaded, nobody out.
Yeah, a team that came in hitting 406 as a squad with the bases loaded this year. Thank you. James Karinchak. This is not an enviable position to be in. He's got to find it and find it fast. He's thrown seven pitches and only one of them has been a strike.
You know, this is why one reason where you'd be afraid to bring him in with any runners on base. He almost needs a clean inning, you know, to bring him into a ball game, and that's what Tito did here in the seventh. It's a clean inning, but he's making it a lot tougher on himself.
He just ramped up and blew it by Ohtani. 2-1. That was 97 miles an hour.
I just want to see him hit his location.
Up the ladder at 97, and Ohtani says, I'm going to need a minute.
Yeah, the harder they throw, right now Ohtani's swinging harder, and he's going out of the zone. So now he gets the count back to even. That was a ball out of the strike zone, and now a chance for the strikeout. I'd try one more up there if he wants to swing at it. He got that one down. You want it upstairs a little bit more than that.
And the 2-2. Backed him off, full count. And he's walked the first two. Anthony Rendon to the plate. Rendon flied to deep center field in the first inning. He doubled and scored in the fourth and singled in the fifth. And out comes Carl Willis. And we'll get a word from Rally House.
Play ball, Cleveland. Shop the latest in Guardian style with your favorite brands and throwback designs. Rally House has gear for every fan.
Angel De Los Santos up in the Cleveland bullpen. Carl Willis either out there to offer some type of a mechanical adjustment for Karinchak to be able to get that ball down into the strike zone with his fastball, or maybe trying to get ahead with his curveball first.
I think he's just trying to, he's overthrowing. You know, you're facing those two hitters, you know, and you think you have to get something extra. You've got to make your pitch and just be natural, but hit your spot. But there it is, the curveball for the first time tonight on strike one, but he missed. This is a guy, I don't know if you can get him to chase up there. He looks, standing in that batter's box, he just looks so relaxed and watches his arms. He's like in a little crouch waiting for you, and then all of a sudden.
A little tardy on that 97 mile an hour fastball. That one, he powered it down at the bottom of the strike zone. Rendon pops it straight up. Naylor coming in from first calls for it. And foul ground. Out number one. That's going to bring up Hunter Renfroe. Renfroe is 1-for-3 tonight. He just blooped a single into center field that loaded the bases in the fifth.
That's the third ball that Karinchak is throwing out.
He's like, here, you pick
one. Yeah, take one, will you, please? Like, I'm done reaching in.
Have you ever seen that before?
Not since this year.
No. You just go, hey, you tell me which one you want.
Yeah,
I'm sick of throwing
take your
you.
Pick, pal. I'm not going to keep throwing them.
Swing and a miss. Renfroe went after that first pitch curveball, and it disappeared.
Yeah, that just tells me they're guessing a little bit. He saw a lot of fastballs prior to him coming up. It was the last at bat he did throw a first pitch curveball, but he missed with it. And if he throws a good one, there's not much you're going to do with it. I'd be looking maybe for a fastball, but you got to make him get it down about belt high or lower. Now he comes back. Yeah, now he comes back with a good one.
Now it's 0-2.
I think he picked the right ball.
Well, now we'll have to try another one.
I mean, this is, you see Gallagher, he was slapping that glove down. If you get it, miss down with it. And look at him, he just moved over and just let that thing come up and hit his chest protector. Dropped it right down in front of him. Well done.
Two on, one out. Tie game, seventh inning, 1-2 pitch on the way. Still 2-2. Leads the team with 10 home runs. Karinchak trying to put him away with a 2-2 pitch, and it's up high, full count. Check, did he go? They said he did, and that is a big strikeout for James Karinchak. Two down.
Well, you're going to see the sequence. He was done in by the swinging at that first pitch, and then he dropped a good curveball on him. So he was down in the count, and then he missed with two curveballs, and he fouled one off, and then elevated that heater. He didn't go, but he didn't. He should have laid off again. He couldn't do it. Hitters get too antsy. You get into that 3-2 count and they want to hit everything. And for Karinchak, he got his second out on the strikeout.
Drury jumped that curveball, but way out in front of it. Breaking ball spins that curveball in there to get ahead. 0-2 now. little high with that fastball. Even two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, when you look at him, I mean, he's throwing more balls than strikes in the inning. 27 pitches, 15 of them balls, 12 have been strikes. And you've had guys swing out of the zone as well.
Struck him out looking, and Karinchik throws his hands to the heavens as he gets out of trouble after walking the first two. Stretch time in Cleveland, still tied at three.
Hey fans, I'm breaking down MLB Play. I think they're the best MLB games. Now my personal favorite, Beat the Streak. Pick who you'll think will get a hit, building your own streak. It's all on you, baby. You can win 5.6 million bucks. The streak's alive! Next up, Pickle. Guess the player in the fewest number of tries. Got him! And there's other games like Bingo, a race to be first. Bingo! MLB Play. Great games, great prizes, and it's all free. No purchase necessary. Restrictions apply. See official rules and enter at MLB.com/play. Oh yeah!
You want highlights? Quick Pitch has you covered. Packing all today's biggest plays into one lightning fast hour.
What a play!
We live today, preview tomorrow on Quick Pitch. Late nights and every morning, only on MLB Network.
Copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Cleveland Guardians and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Cleveland Guardians. The new pitcher for the Angels is 33-year-old Matt Moore. He'll be 34 next month. Last year, pitched in 63 games out of the bullpen for the Texas Rangers and had a 1.95 ERA. You talk about a guy that has remade himself. Way back in 2011, he was a 22-year-old rookie who had pitched in three games in the regular season and then showed up in the postseason and pitched 10 innings in the division series and gave up one run. A couple years later, he was a 17-game winner, and everybody thought, man,
he's going to be around forever.
He's going to be a phenom, right? Yeah. And then, poof, just like that. Bouncing ball to first. Stephen Kwan retired for out number one. Yeah, he's gone all over the place. San Francisco, Texas, Detroit, Philadelphia, back to Texas, and now the Angels. And we're back out of play. Ahmed Rosario, 2 for 3. He tripled and scored in the first. That's hammered deep left field. Back goes Ward. It's over his head and off the wall. And into second base with his third hit of the night is Amed Rosario. And it's his fourth double on the year.
Looks like he did Amed a favor. Tried to change speeds on him, and he roped this off a wall. He went down in the end with an off-speed pitch that he just rattles off the wall.
Arch, all Amed needs is for Matt to have his birthday, and he turns into a different hitter. Matt gets older, and he keeps getting hits.
He gets younger.
He gets younger. Hey, something else to remember about the Angels. I know that was talked about in the Guardians meeting before the game. The Angels came in with 28 errors. That's tied for the most in baseball. There's going to be a walk here, but that's just something to remember about this Angels team. They have kicked the ball around more than anyone else in baseball.
They sure have. They've given up more unearned runs than any team. 25 unearned runs allowed this year.
Fans don't like the intentional walk to Jose.
What's that, number eight?
Ramirez. Eighth time he's been intentionally walked. And number 20 overall in the year. So two on, one out, and Josh Bell coming up. Nice block. Yeah, I mentioned before with Matt Moore, you know, he came up 22 years old. Looked like he was going to be a phenom for a long time. But injuries have a way of derailing young careers. Tommy John surgery, knee surgery. But to his credit, he's hung around. One ball and two strikes. With the go-ahead run in scoring position and one out here in the seventh. Bouncing ball to short. There's one and two. So a two for one ball gets the Angels out of trouble in the seventh, and we're still tied at three.
To get your best night's sleep, you need to sleep in something extraordinary. Woven with a silky softness unlike any other. From organic threads that are slow spun and finished in flame. Made from an ingredient so rare, less than 1% of the world's cotton meets our quality. It's the most extraordinary fabric ever made. Only from Boll & Branch.
Sure, you'll teach her how to drive a car. Then use Greenlight to power her independence. With crash detection with 911 dispatch, family location sharing, and emergency SOS alerts. Invest in your best investment with Greenlight.
We love going to games, but good seats get pricey, so we use Game Time. Game Time checks ticket prices in real time and finds you all the best last-minute deals. We got our seats 20 minutes ago for 60% off. Last-minute tickets at the best price in seconds. Download Game Time now.
Now come down to the ballpark when the Guardians take on the Angels tomorrow night. 10,000 fans will receive a Gold Glove trophy for one of the Guardians' four Gold Glove winners. That's tomorrow night, 6 o'clock ball game. As we continue this weekend series, Here in the eighth inning, Gio Urshela will lead it off. Trevor Stephan on the pitch for Cleveland, fourth pitcher of the night. Urshela tonight is 1-for-3. He had an RBI double and scored the tying run, or at that time it was the go-ahead run, I should say, for the Angels back in the fourth inning. Last time up, he was in a key spot. Bases loaded, only one out. And he banged into a double play to end the inning.
Yeah, that was the turnaround inning of this game.
Guardians came back in the bottom half of that frame and tied the game at 3. We have stayed that way. Now into the eighth inning. Urshela out with a 7-game hitting streak. Stephan's 0-2 pitch blew the fastball by him. Well, it was eventful, but James Karinchak got through the seventh inning after he walked the first two batters. He got Anthony Rendon to pop up on the infield. And he had to work hard to strike out Hunter Renfroe on a check swing and then throws Drury to end the inning. Matt Theis, 1-for-2. He walked in the fourth. One ball, one strike. Just a little high on the check swing. He did not go. Finds the hole and gets into center field. A one out single for Matt Theis here in the eighth.
He's been on 3 times tonight. 2 singles and a walk.
And a word now from SumaCare.
I built my own Medicare Advantage plan with SumaCare.
Introducing Jade HMO with Beneflex, exclusively from SumaCare.
Zach Neto, 1-for-3, an RBI single back in the fourth. Out of play. Now, Arch, 98 years ago today, Italian immigrant parents in the city of St. Louis, Missouri welcomed a son into the world. They named him Lawrence Peter Barra. His friends, namely his best friend who grew up across the street from him, Joe Garagiola, they called him Lodi, because that's the way, with their Italian accent, when his parents tried to say Lawrence, it came out something like Lodi. And that was his nickname until Lodi and his friends went to the movies one day and they saw a film. It featured a young boy, a character playing a Hindu yogi. And one of his friends said, hey, that guy looks like Lodi. And ever since that day, he was known as Yogi Berra. Even his parents called him Yogi. Driven a deep left field. That might be trouble. And it is off the wall. Played well by Kwan. But the throw misses the cutoff man. Now coming home. And the throw backed up by Ramirez. And he threw it perfectly to Gallagher to tag out Theis for out number 2.
Can't believe they sent the catcher in that situation.
That went from almost a disastrous relay to a really good one.
It sure did. And I mean, when you watch it all the way and play out, Kwan played this ball well and got it in. His throw was just a little offline coming to third. But Ramirez made the play to go get it. He thought it was going to roll all over, and he was done by about 10 feet. And remember, that's your catcher. his pathway to throw the ball. He couldn't even slide, and they get the out at home play. What a big out that was.
Bounce foul, third base side.
Relay goes 7-5-2, and he didn't even have time to slide, nor did he try.
That can't be a good feeling when you're a base runner.
Right.
And you see the ball arrive, and you're still another five, six feet away.
Uh-oh. Right. There's nothing you can do. And Gallagher's a pretty big guy.
Yes, Rick, in that instance, Quan, his instincts as he turned around was to throw to third base rather than look for Rosario, who was out there in the cutoff position. Unfortunately for him, Ramirez was able to gather it in and fire it in there to home plate. Rosario is there. The inning is over. Another interesting turn of events here in the eighth. We're still tied at 3.
They said optical shops weren't very inviting. So we, Warby Parker, created ones that were. They said prescription eyewear was too expensive. So we offered more affordable glasses, contacts, and eye exams. They said opticians weren't always friendly. So we hired only the friendliest and the most knowledgeable. And finally, they said the whole experience was just kind of unpleasant. So we set out to change that too. Visit a Warby Parker store and see for yourself.
Take control of your health by boosting your force field, the immune system. With the Aura Ring, you can listen to your body's signals and raise your defenses. Aura tells you when your temperature is higher than normal, how to improve your sleep, or if your heart rate shows signs of stress. So you can decide to push yourself or to lie low. Live smarter, stronger, healthier with the Aura Ring.
Score, bottom of the eighth inning. Matt Moore worked a scoreless seventh. He worked around a one out double by Ahmed Rosario. They intentionally walked Jose Ramirez, and it paid off handsomely when Josh Bell grounded into an inning-ending double play. Now the lefty-lefty matchup with Josh Naylor leading off the eighth. Stays alive.
It's a to take. Wanted to see if he wanted to chase one out off the plate. He did not.
Just outside and a full count, so Josh patiently waiting him out here. And Naylor will spend his time out. There's a ball boomed into the deep right center field. Goodbye. Josh Naylor with just his fourth hit of the year off the left-hander. But that one was quite emphatic indeed. Home run number four on the year, RBI number 20, and the Guardians lead it 4-3.
Well, he settled in. He took that time out, did the full count, and he ended up getting a nice fastball, and he did not miss it. He drove that one into the pens. Nice to score a run when you don't have to get three hits in an inning. That was beautiful.
Gabriel Arias makes a breaking ball for a strike. That's now 11 runs knocked in for Naylor in his last 13 games. And that is what you call clutch. Eight. Has time now to get loose. Two balls and two strikes. Chases after it for strike three. First home run of the year allowed by Matt Moore. It was a no doubter.
Yeah, I mean, he stayed back nicely. And as soon as it left the bat, he knew it. You can't get much more of that.
Andres Jimenez takes a fastball outside. Two and oh, Jimenez. Opposite field single in the second, bunted for a hit in the fourth, and fly to left in the sixth inning. Three and count for Jimenez. Right field. Renfro back on the track and can make the play. Jimenez on his way to third, and he's in there safely with a triple. That's his first of the year and the second of the night for Cleveland. It's their sixth extra base hit of the game.
Well, we talked earlier in the day how that ball looked like it had some carry. He put a good swing on this. Fastball out over the plate, got a pretty good extension. Going back, Renfro. He just didn't know where he was. He never got back there in time to make a play. It hits at the face of the wall. I mean, the maximum base down there. And they get it in. Trout comes over, but not before Jimenez can get the third. So there you go. A little more insurance.
Last time the Guardians had six extra base hits in the game was April 23rd against the Marlins. But now they're looking for one more run at least. Miles Straw to the plate with Jimenez at third and one out. Angels will bring the infield in. Matt Wise, the pitching coach, out for a chat. Straw shot a double up the right center field alley his last time up.
Yeah, and Urshela, who's at first, is playing way in on the grass in case he tries to push one down there for Jimenez. But he let it go, and he's charging as that pitch is delivered. Last at bat, a beautiful double that he picked up off the ground below the strike zone and drove it to right center. Trying to stay in and not give him any room, and maybe that's what they were talking about. Don't give him anything away to push. It's a big run. Get it in.
Change up. Finds its mark and it's 2-2. Cleveland with four runs on the board. Only once in their last 10 games have they reached the four-run plateau.
But that's been a good number for them. 11-2 when they score four.
Right field near the line. Renfro makes the grab, tagging and bluffing for a move towards home. Was Jimenez, and now there are two down.
That's the one guy you don't run on. I can tell. He's got a great arm out there. You talk about the three runs or fewer. They've done that in 65% of their games so far this year. They only did that 44% of the time last year, guys. 6-18 this year when they don't score four runs.
Two down, Cam Gallagher, the batter. Fastball just above the zone. And he popped him up on the shallow part of center field. Trout comes in to make the catch, and that will end the inning. We'll go to the ninth. Josh Naylor puts the Guardians in front. Bring on Klassen.
The next generation of baseball has arrived.
And I am here for it.
Keep an eye on the new faces of baseball on Off Base, the modern baseball show for the modern baseball fan.
It's all about things you haven't seen before.
Only on MLB Network.
Jeremy Peña, the world champion shortstop with movie star presencia.
Every Dominican wants to grow up and play baseball, bro.
When I was 13, I was like, the plan is to get to the big leagues.
I love seeing young Dominicans win, bro, because I'm an old Dominican.
Ya tú sabes que el dominicano que juega, todo el mundo juega pelota.
Pelota, claro.
Hey, we're just looking forward to playing again, man. This is going to be a fun year.
Salud a la vida más fina.
Salud, hermano.
when it's about to go down.
This is the story of the night.
MLB Tonight takes you there.
We will watch it all together live.
Big moments.
Oh, baby. 3,000 hits.
Big reactions.
Bobby Witt Jr.'s first big league knock.
And big interviews.
What was the first thing going through your mind?
Join TV's best baseball analysts for a big night of baseball. Every night, only on MLB Network's MLB Tonight.
It's a one-run Cleveland lead, and this is one reason why.
Well, he smokes the ball. It's going to go off the wall. Now, watch Kwan throw. He pulled that throw, but the third base coach is going to hold him up, and we'll look at it again, and then restart him. Now, you see, he wanted to hold him up at first, and then he restarts him, and that's a catcher. That's not an easy thing to do as a coach, but he was not going to send him until he saw Kwan make that throw, and it was offline, but Ramirez made the adjustment and able to get him at home plate. So good play defensively by Jose. Third base coach will think twice about doing that again.
Emmanuel Clase on for the 21st time this year, looking for his 14th save. And this might be the toughest one he's had to get on the year, because he'll have Trout, Ohtani, and Rendon to go through here in the ninth.
This is how it usually happens, isn't it? You get the three best right at the end.
Missed inside. Will Brennan in the game now defensively in right field. Tough to catch up to, 2-1, even with the count in your favor. And even when your name is Mike Trout, it's 2-2.
That's a way of bringing out the best in you, doesn't it?
It better. There's a ball blasted up the left center field alley. Trout with great speed. He'll get to second base, and it's a leadoff double.
Yeah, he got this one down. Now, Mike Trout, notoriously a terrific low ball hitter. This one came down a little bit and cut, and that was right into his path. Look at him. That looked so natural right there. And then found the hole in the alley. You can see where Straw was playing him, way over in right center field. Well, that'll be a double. They get their leadoff man aboard.
Shohei Ohtani has walked twice on the night and struck out once. Just shaved the outside corner at 100 miles an hour.
I mean, when you look at the spot, you can't hit it, so you got to take it. And maybe that's close, awfully close. Did a great
pitch
job.
Was in the same spot.
I know it. That's what he would have had to do to swing at it. But when you get to two strikes, if he put one there and comes right back with the same pitch, you better try to foul it off. He did a tremendous job just to foul it off. Now go outside a little further, see if he wants to go out. Maybe just a ball width.
He laid off, and now the count is full. Knowing Classe, he's going to go at him and challenge him here, even with that base open. And he did. How about that? A nasty slider to strike him out.
Well, he was seeing nothing but fastballs, and you have nothing to go off of. Then he comes back with that slider, and Ohtani said, I can't believe it. You tip your cap and say, sorry, you got me. What a great pitch. First one he's seen in the at bat.
Now here's Anthony Rendon. Puts a slider off the plate for ball one. Rendon has two hits tonight, a double, single, and a run score. And he shoots it into right field. Tying run will stop at third. And the Angels have runners at the corners with one out. And Hunter Renfro coming to the plate. Boy, you're right. Rendon, he looks just so nonchalant up there at the plate. And then bang.
Strikes like a cobra, man. He comes out of there. That's a breaking ball. Look at him stay down through it. That's the 12th hit now for the Angels.
Hunter Renfro awaits the pitch, and it's high ball one. Mike Trout, the tying run at third base.
Yeah, he needs the punchy here.
Wow, but that was an incredible leaping grab by Gallagher on a 99 mile an hour fastball.
Pull his arm out of socket, having to reach up there. Boy, that saves a run.
Slider, 2-2.
Well, he's got the opportunity now. There you go. He was looking down the middle. That ended up being a perfect pitch with that little slide piece on the outside edge just off.
Challenged him with a fastball in.
Oh my goodness.
Pop back out of play. Boy, you know, just the reaction time it takes for major league hitters on a pitch that's coming at him at 100 miles an hour. It's just incredible.
Yes, it is. Believe me, they're fighting. They're just hoping that, you know, they can just get the bat to the ball. He's just trying to get that man in from third. And Classe's doing everything in his power. He's throwing sliders. He's fouled off fastballs.
Well, this will be the eighth pitch of the at bat for Renfro. And time called here. We're going to get a pinch runner now. And that is going to be Brett Phillips, who comes on to run for Rendon at first base. That's the go-ahead run for the Angel. Kind of a weird time to make your substitution.
Yeah, 2-2.
Maybe that was almost, hey, let's give him a second to catch his breath.
Well, that, or maybe they just wanted to, no, not that. Send him and stay out of the double play. Because Phillips can steal a base, and they're not really paying attention to him. They're going for the punch out right here.
Two and two to count. Runner goes. And a ground ball. They stay out of the double play. Jimenez's throw to the plate is offline. And now the go-ahead run is at third base.
That's exactly why he started the runner right there. You stay out of a double play. It was a good at-bat by Renfro just to put the ball in play. If he doesn't send him, it's a double play ball. And then game's over. I think they're talking about something. Well,
Trout kicks the ball away.
I was going to say.
And he kind of, I think it was inadvertent, but he did kick the ball. I don't think it really impacted the play.
But maybe to get him to third base. Yeah, that's an error on the throw from Jimenez.
The second baseman for LA, Brandon Drury.
So Brandon Drury now has a chance to put the Angels in front. Center field, Straw makes the catch, tagging Phillips coming home, and he will score, and the Angels lead 5-4. Just as a point of defenders in that situation for Jimenez, is it too big a risk to try and get the guy at home? You just, you know, concede the tie, get the out, get that winning run.
Yeah, you could do that. Yes, you probably should have done that because he was playing back. He wasn't expecting it.
If he's
and
in,
then he
I know.
Took off. Well, yeah. Then he took off. So yeah. His mind just says, I got to try for the guy at home play, but you got to make a perfect throw. And everything has to just fall into place, which it did not.
And that will send us to the bottom of the ninth, but now the Guardians are down one.
Think baseball.
There's something that's been missing in the debate.
Think analysis.
Now he goes into his contract year. What do you do with this guy?
Think advanced metrics.
The new rules are having an impact, and I'll bottom line it.
Think MLB Now, the show for the thinking fan, only on MLB Network.
The hot dog at the game beat roast beef at the Ritz.
2 chain.
What's that on that beat?
I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing. I'm different, yeah, I'm different.
Thank you. Stay tuned for Guardians Live postgame with Al Pawlowski and Chris Jimenez coming up next. Right now, we are going to the bottom of the ninth inning. Carlos Estevez is on to pitch for the Angels. He has eight saves and eight save opportunities. And a sparkling ERA of 1.02 in 17 and two-thirds innings. He's allowed 200 runs on nine hits.
Unscored upon in 15 of his 17 outings. So they're at the top of the lineup. They're going to have to try and come back and do their thing.
Brandon Drury goes from second base to first base. Luis Ranjifo is the new second baseman, and Gio Urshela moves from first base over to third.
Number 23, Brandon Drury.
And I think that takes care of everything. A lot of changes here late in this game. What a comeback for the Angels. They score two in the top of the ninth, and now the Guardians must rally. Top of the order, Stephen Kwan will lead it off. He's 0 for 3. He walked and scored back in the fifth. And Estevez with the fastball strike. Estevez made 62 appearances for the Rockies last year, and after the All-Star break in 26 outings, he had an ERA of just 1.40. Signed a two-year deal with the Angels after the season. And it's now 2-2. Seats. Full count. Payoff pitch. Popped up again.
This one back. Might stay in play.
And it will. One down. Brings up Amet Rosario. He has three more hits tonight, including a double and a triple. He's a home run shy of the cycle. Eight hits in his last 15 at-bats. And that fastball, actually a slider, missed outside. Fastball 98 though, and found it back 2-2 to count.
Hey, he's not messing around. He's coming right there with the hard stuff. He hasn't messed around yet. Here it is. See if you can hit it.
to break the ball. Yeah, sooner or later you have to try and throw a breaking ball, especially when you stay at a couple of good hacks at his fastball. Got it inside.
In front of the Angels dugout and caught. Drury hangs on, two down. Back-to-back foul outs.
I mean, that just caught in. It tried to come out. Look at it. Almost came out the top.
It's down to Jose Ramirez. Probably didn't end up exactly where Estevez wanted it, but
that's just to take him off the fastball, knowing that Jose is such a good fastball hitter.
And the 1-2 pitch is blooped into center field for a base hit. And the Guardians aren't done yet. So Ramirez with his second hit of the night. And the tying run is aboard with two outs in the ninth.
And he throws that little breaking ball, but it's down. And he jammed him. He just floats it into center field, but it's a base knock. It keeps the inning going and gives Josh Bell an opportunity.
It's interesting. The pitcher, Estevez, went out to the home plate umpire, and he was wiping his hand off on the grass. Josh Bell the batter. He is 0 for 3. He walked in the third. Bell awaits the pitch. Ripped into right field. Ramirez will go to third. The tying run is 90 feet away after a ringing line drive base hit off the bat of Josh Bell. This appears to be the manager, Phil Nevin, going out to talk to his closer, Estevez. It is, and he is very animated. He's challenging his big guy. You saw the pinch runner, Tyler Freeman, on for Josh Bell to run at first base. He's the winning run now. Last time up, Josh Naylor.
Yeah, the fastball out over the plate that he certainly loved, and it gave him a lead, a one-run lead at the time, made it a 4-3 ball game.
And they just intentionally walked Josh Naylor here. And as Naylor took his intentional walk, he turned back towards home plate and was encouraging Will Brennan, who's going to get an opportunity now. Brennan just came on for defense in the top of the ninth inning. So this is his first at bat of the night. Got after that first pitch fastball, but fouled it back. Bases loaded, two out. Guardians down one.
Whoa.
And almost to the backstop, and a great job by Theis, just as Gallagher did in the top half of this inning.
Yes.
Reached up and snared a fastball.
Yeah, no kidding. I mean, catchers, they can't even see that ball. That's above what they see. They just throw their arm up, and that happened to go in.
Caught in between. And now the Guardians are down to their last strike. Never heard the attendance tonight, but everybody here is up on their feet. And the 1-2 struck him out. And the Angels hang on for a one-run win. And for the Guardians, another tough one-run loss. They're now 8-10 on the year in one-run games. 5-4 is the final score as the Angels go to 21-18 on the year. And the Guardians fall to now 17-21 on the season. Carlos Estevez hangs on for the save. It's his ninth. The loss to Emmanuel Clase. It's his third. He's now 1-3. And Phil Nevin's club draws first blood in the series. They earned it. They had to get Clase in the ninth. And, you know, the big boys came through. Trout, Anthony Rendon.
Yeah.
They set it up. And then, again, the defensive play, easy to second guess. Jimenez tried to come home with a throw, but it really, not only did they get the tying run, but they were able to get the winning run to third base, and the sac fly got him home.
Yeah, that was sad. A tough one. He had a chance to strike out Renfro, but what an at-bat he put together to get that tying run. Hit the ground ball. They pinch ran at the perfect time. There was two strikes on him. Knowing that he could stay out of the double play, he started him. They do. And Clase blows his fourth save.
So 5-4 is the final. We're back tomorrow with game two of this three-game series here at Progressive Field. Stay tuned now for Guardians Live postgame with Al and Chris Jimenez coming up next.